destroy each time.
Oh my goodness.
But this will be a learning experience. Buffering should be gone now, guys, too. And also, don't be afraid to use your foreign fruits and like your dodge roll.
Oh no! Oh no! No! Why? I can't jump.
You can survive this. Just keep moving. Like I said, this is not my favorite level.
That was crazy. Oh my god. Okay, hello everyone. Hi. It's so good to see you. Not really at all. Okay, thanks. Jesus Christ.
Oh, you died?
This is the worst.
Hello everybody, welcome to System Shock Plays Risk of Rain.
Yeah, pretty much.
We're being hosted across two channels. I'm so sorry, I should never have recommended this.
I'm just gonna turn off my webcam. Like, at this point, it's just like, alright, this is the
no,
System
no, no,
Shock
no,
channel.
Please, please, keep it on. It keeps me going. I'm like, do it for her.
That's the only redemption my cast has right now.
Yeah. Talk to Beast.
Armor.
I am gonna wreck this so hard. So here's a tip for you when you grow up and you start playing this on your own. I'm sorry.
Wow. So
one of the nice things about the Toxic Beast that you can do is you can basically run out the time and you can kill everything else. And what it winds up doing is it winds up spawning these little beastlings. So the reason why that's helpful is I have this infuser item, right? Which gives me extra health based on the number of things that I kill. And so the end result of this is that the toxic beasts spawn are not that hard to... I'm probably going to die here.
Don't die. It's rich coming from me.
It's the secret to all these games. Don't die. It's really these flying things that are monsters. Mm-hmm. But as long as I can survive another 3 seconds, I've got the foreign fruits. Definitely not lying when I say they're game savers. Unfortunately, these flying Lemurians are really,
Right.
Really pains. So anyways, the idea here is that I'm not that worried about, actually, you know what? This is the right way to do it. I'm gonna take care of the flying ones because we're at 90 seconds now. So these little piggies are gonna get, spawned each, throughout the level, right? But in the end, they're not actually that hard to deal with. So what this winds up doing is it gives me a whole lot of like very easy enemies to kill, which my infuser translates into health. And so you don't actually, like unlike those other boss fights where I killed the boss right away, I'm actually leaving it alive just because it's going to be spawning a really nice little resource for...
That's amazing.
For health, yeah.
I'm so sorry to hear that, Kira. But I'm glad to hear that you're okay. But... This is really interesting. The strategy that you have.
Well, it's all... In the end, like, this is just kind of the product of playing the game, you know, letting it, like, kick my ass so many times over. And, you know, just getting to that point where I say it's like, okay, well, what's one thing I can do when I have this boss that I hate? Like, for instance, I hate wisps. Like, they always just do so much damage to me. And in this case, I'm just saying, well, they're on a ledge. There's not a lot that I can do, but I can have my foreign fruits and hit it whenever, whenever it gets too scary. And then if it gets too intense, I always just jump off the edge. I've got 35 seconds on my foreign fruits, and I've also got this egg. So yeah, I'm taking a lot of damage right now. I say, okay, relax, head back down. It will only take 20 seconds, and then I can head back up. And then, seeing as I'm out of combat, notice that my health is going up quite a bit because of this healing egg. Now, it's not efficient for the overall difficulty of the game. There's a reason why you're finding the beginnings of these levels very hard, and it's because the game is progressing faster than you've been able to progress through the levels, which is why getting items in this game is so important. But here, of course, now I've got my foreign fruits back up. I hit it, I've got full health, and I can wipe these guys out. So in this case, I try and use health as like a resource to be consumed. So again, I'm almost dead. So I head back out. I've managed to unseat that wisp, which is great. That's sort of what I needed. Now I'm down to 43 health, so again, it's not fun to sit and wait, but I prefer winning to dying. And it only... Basically, all that I really need is a... there we go. I need, like, one good sniper shot, and by killing it, I also get some extra health, so now I'm sort of able to...
Sure.
To go in and clear out the next wave. And it's worth noting, right, like, at the start of this, like, down below sequence, I was at 544 health. Now I'm at 592.
Okay.
So just by, you know, taking this little detour, I've made myself much more survivable. And
right.
I'm going to kind of rinse and repeat this for the next little while. Just clearing out all these wisps, taking advantage of positioning. And again, because I triggered the boss, I don't need to worry about any more enemy spawning except for these little piggies, which I can I know I can handle.
Okay.
And then, of course, it also gives me money. Monster Tooth is another great one, so I heal after kills.
Wow.
And as you can see, like, I'm starting to just mow through enemies pretty simply.
Mm-hmm.
And just generally be a little bit more confident in terms of what I'm facing up against.
That's great.
Hey, MoFaShow17. We're playing Risk of Rain with the fine caster, Jesse Quill, who presently is dead in this level.
I'm a great caster, but not a wonderful gamer, so...
You are a wonderful gamer, but when you get thrown into a difficult game without really any warning...
That I've never played before.
Yeah. You curiously behave about as good as I did in the game when I started, so...
Okay, all right. That makes me feel better.
Did you get that achievement out of curiosity?
I didn't think I saw one.
Okay. And forgive me, guys, for not being a little more directly responsive in chat, but I think for those of you who've played this game, I think you can understand why. Oh, another infusion.
I love the music in this game.
Yeah, it's a wonderful score. Notice here I'm kind of okay doing, just kind of yelling YOLO and going up on this ledge against tough enemies because I have those foreign fruits.
Mm-hmm.
Now because I've blown the fruits, I've got 40 seconds, and so I'm going to try and do as much damage as I can, make the best use of those dodges where I can. But if I go sort of any, let's say a quarter health, I'm going to want to back off and regroup. Like, so this is really dangerous for me.
Blitzkrieg! Yes, I did get my studio set up. Thank you very much. It was incredibly spontaneous and a surprise. And I checked my P.O. box on Thursday, I think? Or, no, Friday. I came home early from work, and I checked my P.O. box, and I was just going to pick up a book that I was gifted. And
a book? Who the hell sends books?
Oh, God. People who really understand exactly what I want.
Okay.
And so I got the studio lights, and so it was a 6-foot package by 2 feet and with a depth of like 6 inches or whatever, something around there. And so I was like, oh, I can't carry that. Can you just like hold on to that and I'll bring like my cart from home? And they're like, no, as soon as it leaves, like as soon as we take it off the shelf, you have to take it or we send it back. And I was like, are you serious? I can't carry this. I don't have anything to carry it with. And they're like, sorry, that's not my problem. And so I had to drag it home.
Thanks, Obama.
Yeah, it was crazy. I was so upset. And yeah, Dad, this game is called Risk of Rain. It's really difficult, but I like it. Or maybe I just like System Shock's explanations. I don't know. It's very hard to tease out the differences between that.
MoFaShow, the answer is always play Risk of Rain. You can't play Sniper. I actually really love... Oh, you need more people. Right now I'm enjoying the fine presence of a... Seriously, check out her stream. A very comely young lady.
I know comely is like a great word, but it just sounds wrong. Like, it just sounds like it's not actually a happy word.
Well, I mean, it's better than pulchritudinous.
Ugh, that's true.
It's like the ugliest word.
I know, my post office was so rude, Dad. But yeah, Blitzkrieg, no worries. I really appreciate it, and it made me definitely appreciate that That is a very long trek to do with a... weighed it, yeah. And so I weighed myself, and then I weighed not only the bag that I had, because it was my last day at work, so I had my whole entire fucking cubicle in a bag, okay? And then I had my purse and my coat and et cetera, et cetera. And then I had also the studio light set up. So I weighed all of that, and I was carrying 98 pounds of extra weight.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I was actually going to ask...
I got a workout. Thank you very much.
You said a fucking cubicle, and I don't mean to pry as to the nature of your work, but that doesn't sound like the kind of job I would want to leave. Mo for show, twitch.tv/JessieBlow. She may even be in chat. You can click on it. Hey, there she is.
Make a multi-twitch link for us.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. That's what professional streamers do.
Then why are we doing it? So not professional.
By the way, I know obviously we've been kind of talking about other stuff, but did you kind of see how I went through those last kind of levels, which is it's sort of building up this big stack of enemies and just finding some kind of a ledge that I can take them on. So this is going to be another prototypical example. These wisps are going to just completely destroy me. So I try and reduce the damage. I can actually start off by... I don't worry about the pigs, so I just kind of soak up the damage from them. But I'm going to be able to deal with these buffalo or whatever the hell they are just by the ledge, and that's going to lead me down to the wisps in a second. And again, I'm not worried about any of these little pigs spawning, because I know I'm strong enough for them. And you'll probably remember where I said I had 500-something health using the strategy
right,
with
590.
Yeah, I'm at 837 now.
Holy sh! I only had, like...
Remember your new job.
Barely... Yeah, I had... some chalk! I had, like, 200 at the beginning of this level.
Yeah. And I was going to say, like, this isn't even a question of, like, your skill, because at this point we're 40 minutes into the game. You've got the kind of health that you would expect at the very beginning of the game, basically. And so you're going up against enemies that are sort of prepared for somebody who's equipped like I am.
Right.
With, like, the stuff that you would kind of have at the beginning. And like that's unfortunate, the way the game works, right? And in some ways, like, I've made this harder for you by going on this big, long epic. But the nice thing is that, theoretically, as long as you can, like... the big thing right now is just avoid enemies, and I'll be able to like, tank a little bit for you.
Okay.
Or alternatively, we say screw this and stop turning it into, like, the System Shock performance hour.
I don't mind.
Repulsion armor. It's usually where I put on my fedora and talk about my views on women.
I have a link, a Twitter thing if you guys want to retweet to let your friends know you're having so much fun hanging out here watching System Shock completely own my ass at Risk of Rain. So, and also in there's the multi-stream link, so if you are able, like on a PC or a Mac, to watch both streams, you can open that up and you can see both perspectives and both chats.
Really, you just want to be able to occasionally hear my voice for those times that I do say something, you know, kind of cool. And then Jessica has the better studio setup and the more attractive figure.
I'm sure if, like, you know, you wanted tips on how to set up your green screen and stuff, I know that, you know, it's... yours is not set up properly right now, obviously, because you're not using it, right? So is that... that's the reason why.
I don't even have a green screen.
What's the opposite of my lady? My lord, I guess?
Oh, here's a neat one, guys. So I had to get called in for jury duty at some point. I mean, like, I could have got out of it because I was in school. But, so does anybody want to guess what lawyers say to each other in Canadian courts? Like, how a lawyer addresses another lawyer and how the lawyer addresses the judge. This may be a trick question, or it may be something different.
I thought the judge is like, they say, I'm not actually sure. I don't know about Canada.
Okay, you know what? I really need to learn how to navigate levels. This is getting embarrassing.
You're fine.
I haven't actually met a Canadian who gets this right, by the way. Could you elaborate on the answer, I smell like poop? Okay, I'm going to call him E-Sprite for the benefit of Jesse Quill's chat.
My friend in Canada. What friends? Okay, I think I said something about friend, and that's why. I'm not sure. Oh, Kite, I'm so sorry that you have to shovel so much. That sucks. I'm so glad I don't have to shovel because I don't care. Also, my landlord lives near me, so he's been doing that a lot, so.
E-Sprite got it right. The lawyers in Canada call each other my friend. Which is a little weird for me the first time I heard it, because I'm like, wow, you know, these lawyers really know each other.
My friend. Jeez, yeah. Can Canada get any nicer? It's ridiculous.
So does anybody...
You're not my friend, guy. So when they say that in South Park, they just mean that, you know, you're not a lawyer who has passed your bar, apparently. It's not that they're being rude. They're just not a friend in that regard. I understand now.
Friends with detriments.
That's basically what we are.
Yeah. So does anybody want to hazard a guess as to what they call the judge?
No idea.
Lover.
What?
No, I'm kidding.
Jesus!
So it's really funny to watch people represent themselves in court in Canada because they will always call the judge your honor.
Right.
In Canada, it is my lord.
Oh my god. Okay.
Yeah.
Hello, shiz. Welcome in.
All right, get ready, Jesse. We're on ha 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 difficulty.
Difficulty?
Oh, we're almost near the end.
Lovely. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I would
never want to belong to any club. Thank you very much, Untavenlift. I hope you followed specifically for our exposition on Canadian legal practice. This is, in fact, all... Hey, did you find the exit?
Me? I don't think so.
Okay, it's just a random imp overlord. I don't think you want to go down here.
Ah!
Yeah, just run away. Up. Here. Stand back, ruffians! don't be afraid to use your foreign fruits. Oh, sup, toxic beast.
Believe me, I haven't been.
One thing that might help you is if you have a little cluster of pigs and nothing else in the area, you might find that you're able to, get some extra health, off of this. I am going to be a little bit of a wanker and take a lot of the items, just because in the end, you know, I'm pretty strong.
There's Godzillas now!
I'm sorry, I'm leaving you. Good luck!
Wow. Now you wonder why I die all the time.
I'm trying to find us the exit so we can...
Yeah, that's fine.
I've been doing well, E-Sprite. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, guys, for... Oh, you don't even lift. Thank you.
How do I use items again?
G.
Thanks.
Yeah, we're basically trying to find the exit as quickly as we can, just so we don't get snowed under by this, this monster.
is dangerous to be left alone.
Oh.
Yep. Yep, it is.
Sorry. You survived quite long. So how's your health, by the way?
I didn't see. I think it was at 300.
Okay.
Well, maybe.
It's 100 more than you had before.
Yeah, I'm not sure. They have in the pastor bar, so they're an official avocado. I don't know what that is, Logan. What is that from? Grated shark. I'm doing fine. Great red shark. I felt a little bit sick earlier, and I still do, but it's one of those things where I'm just kind of trying to power through it and consume as much Dayquil and Nightquil as possible, so I feel like I am high. So, yeah.
Dayquil, Nightquil, Jessiequil.
Yep. That's a huge pig reminds me of my boss.
Oh, great, Dad. For crying out loud, the exit was like literally right below us. Oh, I hate these fucking bugs.
Oh.
All right. If you're all betting men and women, let's see whether or not system can survive this.
Oh my goodness. It was from Daredevil. Oh, I don't watch Daredevil. I don't watch TV very often.
The only thing you watch now is depressing shows.
Oh my god, I love Black Mirror so much. I want to watch more, I'm not lying.
Yeah. The first episode of that season, I'm going to try and tantalize with the premise. It's, there's a princess that gets kidnapped. You know, UK still has royalty and all of that.
Right.
And,
a lot of Europe does.
Indeed. The ransom demand is for the PM to perform a bizarre, indecent, and illegal act on public television. And you find him out within the first 10 minutes as to what the demand actually is, but I am sure as hell not telling you.
Yeah, okay. That sounds fun.
The third one is about basically a world where you can completely record memories, and it's a story about a lawyer who begins to maybe suspect that his wife may have conducted some kind of an affair. It was actually, so it used to be my least favorite, and then I watched it again. I actually, there's a lot of very, very interesting ideas in that, that story. And it turns out that that one was picked up by Robert Downey Jr.'s production company. So they may be turning it into a feature film. And then the third season has one where a woman's, boyfriend dies, and there's a grieving service that claims they will sort of resurrect them based on their social media postings, so they'll like create a virtual version.
Oh my god.
Of like all, based on their social media postings, like they'll create an AI. And then they say there's another level to it where they create like an artificial human that, that will.
Like a physical human?
Yeah. Now, the crazy thing, there is a business in the UK now that is actually offering this service. They will create an AI based on your social media postings to basically post as you after you die.
Holy shit.
Yeah, like, when I saw that newspaper article after seeing that episode, I'm like, oh my fucking god.
Yeah. Hello, Ursa. Welcome on in. We're just talking about crazy AI and me dying in Risk of Rain, and just this is a system truck show basically right now.
But it's great because all of your characters' social media posts will be recreated, and I will have companionship on this hostile planet. Holy crap! Look at all these claymen. Ah! That was my war face.
It worked.
Is this even remotely exciting for anybody to watch? I'm so sorry, I'm like not paying attention to chat for reasons that, if they're not apparent, fuck you.
No, it's fine for me. It's mostly the conversation I care about, so.
Okay, fair enough. The only
thing
I regret
is. Thank you so much for having my headphones in so much.
Sorry?
My ears hurt from having my headphones in for so long. So, you regret something, or what were you saying?
Oh yeah, I let my drone die, so I'm gonna have to spend like $1,000 to bring it back. Ply of Wrecking says, "How dare you not watch Twitch chat by being while being mauled by everything?" I'm at 1,243 health, by the way.
Joshy, yeah, that's the exact same sentiment that I have. I don't even care about playing a game. I'm just here to chat. Hi, Weebro. How are you?
Weebro's in the house.
Sucks language, Dad. Get out of here. Don't lie.
Sorry, Dad. I believe in clean language and purity of thought. I would like to take a moment now and recite some passages from Song of Solomon. I actually don't remember Song of Solomon, so... I do, however, remember 1 Corinthians 11:14. Does not even nature itself teach you that it's a shame for a man to have long hair? I think we should all just take a moment and reflect on that beautiful passage.
Say it one more time!
Doth not even nature itself teach you that it is a shame for a man to have long hair?
Why do you remember that?
I have no idea. It's just a very memorable verse.
The only one that I really remember is John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he sent his one and only begotten son. That's all I remember. I don't know why I remember that one.
I mean, everybody quote, like, it's like one of the most famous Bible verses.
Right, yeah. That whoever shall believe in him shall not perish but have eternal life. See, I don't even remember all of it.
Time for my war face again, chat. Ah! Never mind.
Now that I'm looking closer, that lipstick looks
good
on you.
Oh, hey, ukulele!
Wanna, you want a closer look? What's up?
Okay, guys, sorry. I'm abandoning this run so I can see that chat. So I can see your stream. Platforms like this are the worst. If I can, I'd love to, like, knock this, whatever it is, Elder Lemurian, Godzilla, whatever you want to call it, off the edge, but I don't think it will cooperate.
Let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth, for your love is better than wine.
Ah, there's Song of Solomon.
Your name is oil poured out, therefore virgins love you. Draw me after you, let us run. The king has brought me into his chambers.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah, there's lots of good stuff in the Bible.
I think we should talk about, like, the donkey of the Bible.
Balaam's ass?
No, it's in Ezekiel, I think. Let me check.
Sorry if religion offends you, chat, but I'm enjoying this.
Ezekiel 23:20. There she lusted after her lover.
Ah, I remember this one.
Like those of donkeys whose emission were like that of horses.
Why is that in the Bible? Why?
I
need to know that she was with guys who come a lot, okay? Like, please.
See, what I loved was somebody posted this thing about, like, it was like a godly man challenge or something like that. It's like, you know, here's the checklist of things that you need to look for in a man. And, like, they put a whole bunch of Bible verses. I'm like, oh man, that's great, because I've got my Ezekiel test. And I put down that verse without the quote. I just put the actual verse itself.
Right.
Five people liked it without looking at what the contents were.
Of course.
And then...
Yeah,
about,
I was... Sorry, go ahead.
And about 30 minutes later, I got banned.
Oh. Yeah, when I was an angsty teenager and I was, like, rebelling against religion or whatever, whenever people would post, like, oh, post your favorite Bible verse for support for me to look up, for me to read or whatever, or for me to pray about, or, like, when there were guest books that were very religious and stuff in places, I would put Ezekiel 23:20. I was such an asshole. Burn in hell, heathens! Thanks, Dad! Love you, too! You're gonna be right down there with me.
So many toxic beasts, so much health.
specific time or difficulty that the last boss comes out, or do we have to
No, we need to get to the last boss. Yeah, this is the second to last level. We can actually make it to the last boss.
Okay.
That's why I got really excited. Mm-hmm. Or, as you know, as the French say, je suis excité. You know what? If this looks like looks like cheating, it is.
Yeah, it's a little cheesy. Just a little. I love this music so much.
How many times have I beat Risk of Rain? Good question. It'll be the first time on this PC. I know I have got a couple of highlights in the beating Providence. Multiple times by Reckoning. I have not done Monsoon, though. Normally I play it with people who are somewhat new to the game, so I think it would be uniquely unfair to throw them into Monsoon difficulty. Okay, time to return to the cheese strats. J'aime le fromage!
Something about cheese?
I like cheese.
Oh. Me gusta queso.
Very nice. Of course, I knew me gusta just from being one who is with the Epic Memers. By the way, everybody, how are you? Is everyone on fleek tonight?
Oh my god, please, stop. Stop. Jessica, you must be Kolsha, because I can't tuck my eyes off of you. I have no idea what that means, Hacker, but I'm gonna pretend that's a compliment and I'm gonna say thank you. Donde está la biblioteca?
Something about a library.
Where is the library? It's like one of those default terms that people always learn in German. Or, Spanish.
I was gonna say, that's some crazy sound in German. And I mean, you've heard me read Goethe in my barbarian English tongue. I mean, that's saying something.
It was great.
Endor's chalk is as cool as they come.
I will have to agree with that.
So it's worth mentioning I got the War Banner, which is actually a really great item to get, especially near the beginning of the game. If you can get people trapped in like an area around, you can see that War Banner just below. If you can get them trapped in that radius, your firing rate goes up by quite a bit, as does your healing. And so basically you just try and get everybody to kind of cluster around you, and you just completely dominate them.
Hmm. Oh, Hacker, yeah, I don't play Vainglory. No, I know that DZ Live plays it, but I don't.
Only one more enemy.
Cool.
I'm just gonna take a minute to get all the loots.
Apparently Newswipe is a great show made by Charlie Brooker, who's the same dude who does Black Mirror.
Yes, he actually has several wipes. So he does his annual wipe, the 2015 wipe, which I posted in the Team Panda Slack. He originally started with a show called Screen Wipe, then he did News Wipe, and the currently running version is called Weekly Wipe. All of them are fantastic. And I know we were talking not too long ago about British satire. I would say that Charlie Brooker is one of the finest living British satirists. He also had a pretty good, an evening variety show or something like that called 10 O'Clock Live. It had a couple of other British comedians in it, but it didn't seem to go that well. Like, I think they only had one season. And Black Mirror actually wasn't picked up by Channel 4 again, but I believe Netflix is going to be producing it. So.
Bye, Dad.
Bye, Dad. Am I allowed to swear again? So again, we're now an hour into the playthrough, and I'm sort of wasting time, but I've got 3,000 gold. What 3,000 gold is going to do for me is, if I go to the exit right now, it's going to turn into experience. I'm level 15, I'm like armed to the teeth, I've got 1,600 health. So what I want to be doing right now is just getting the last kind of set of items that I can, you know, I can really, really stick it to Providence with. I'm not going to open the $3,000 chest just because it's... That's Donald Trump money, man. So, Chalk's sexy voice put Jesse to sleep. I believe if I were to hypothesize, it might actually be the other way around. But I'll let you know.
We'll try to figure that out. It'd be an interesting experiment. Next song. Good try, Hacker. Why are you trying to do next song? This is part of the game.
And it's a great song. Screw you.
Yeah.
Bonjour. Me. I have no idea how to speak French. My name is John Cena, and my favorite instrument is...
You don't know how to speak French, eh?
No!
Voulez-vous coucher à ma mort?
No.
Damn it!
Oh, my favorite wrestler. Oh, okay. My dad said to your question, am I allowed to curse again? The answer is fuck no.
Thank you, Dad. Have a very good evening. I hope... Okay, so press Q to teleport to the final level, A to revisit the previous levels. Bam! We are going to the flippin' last level, Dad.
Wow, that's so far out, Chalk. It's so heavy.
Okay. I have 400 health, by the way.
Oh, nice. So yeah, the best thing at this point is... Okay, so what we're going to be doing is this level is specifically designed to give us a lot of like little mini-boss encounters. So we're going to have to open the doors, and it takes about 30 seconds each time. So a lot of this level is going to be you dodging through stuff. So again, just don't be afraid to use your forward fruits. I'm going to do as much as I can to try and get their attention, but yeah. I can't control the AI.
Oh my god, why am I in this thing?
Alright, boys. Can I take it on my own? One man. With the memory of his beloved friend. I barely knew you, Commando.
So many fails.
Okay, so a little bit of a tip. I mean, this is going to be a while before you get to the final level. And I don't say this, like, snarkily. Just, that was the case for me. But what I do here is I will trigger all three of the openings. Now, I technically don't need to do this, but there are some items that you can pick up in this level that are really, really helpful in the Providence fight. And you usually get them by sort of exploring the level and getting certain things here. So notice that at this point, I'm just completely ignoring all this stuff trying to kill me. And I'm just running to try and get to these doors as quickly as I can. Because in the end, like even with all of my health, I don't actually want to have to fight all this stuff.
To deal with it, yeah.
Like see, even here, like this is not a very big stack for me to deal with. And even then, they're kind of like burning through my defenses. So in this case, I'm just trying to make do with what I have. And this is purely getting resources because in the end, it is not going to matter whether or not I killed all the monsters. Once I get to Providence, all bets are off. So what I'm specifically looking for here are these little green or these little yellow.
Thanks, Dad. I will make sure that I shoot my donkey horse emission gun at them. Anyway, sorry for interrupting.
No, no worries. Tell me more about this donkey horse gun.
Well, if it actually worked, I'd probably still be alive, but... Fortunately, I think it defeats me just as much as everyone else.
Yeah. What I'm basically looking for here are those little yellow containers. I have no idea why I can't open these ones, but anyways, I won't focus on it. The reason is that they give me key cards, and the more key cards I have, I can do things like bring in a railgun to shoot against him, and something that heals me, and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. So, very, very useful set of items. Usually, I want to get at least two key cards. There are a total of four. Generally, everything you can get out of them is useful. Now here, I'm sort of delaying a little bit. This is just because I've got foreign fruits and I can sort of afford to take the damage. And the big deal here is I'm sort of trying to take advantage of the fact that I have some power, and killing these monsters is going to give me some health. Now again, that's at more or less full health, so it's going to take me a while to take them down, and in the end, I don't think it's worth it. So I will run past the tough monsters, and I'll try and take the low-hanging fruit where I can. Love Lens Maker's glasses, they're sort of like a critical hit chance, and I now have, I think, three of them. Somebody who's looking at the bottom of chat.
Yep, three.
Awesome. I think this is where we came in, but I just want to double check. Yeah, there's already dead stuff here, so.
Native Americans are considered their politically incorrect term is, like, red skin. So, yes, you're right. You probably shouldn't use that term. It's not very sensitive or kind. There's no reason to use it when there's plenty of other terms to describe a group of people.
Yeah. Another good item here that I'm going to pick up is the crowbar. What it does is, I'll say it right here. Basically, if you have a
monster.
Yeah, so if it's a certain amount over a certain threshold, the crowbar will do bonus damage to it. Once it gets on low health, then you cease to get the bonus, but there have been runs that I've been on where I've gotten so many... Well then! There are basically so many crowbars that I've gotten that I've almost, like, one-shot stuff, so it's really handy. Now, my goal of getting two of these keys has been satisfied, and I don't really have any gold right now, so there's no major advantage to me just, like, hanging out here. Although I should pick up the keycard. There we go. I might want to try and kill one of these jellies, but the big thing is that the jelly is going to follow me, so I don't have to, like, I don't have to stand and fight. I just kind of let, you know, nature take its course, and I progress through the level. We're about halfway through at this point, and I can even make it faster if I don't stop to kill stuff, but that's not necessarily an optimal strategy, because again, these big clusters here are very easy for me to take out, and I just hit my four groups. Like, look at all that gold. And again, here I just want to take advantage as much as I can. Dealing damage heals you, fantastic thing for the endgame. Rusty jetpack, so that gives me more mobility. And fire shield, retaliate on taking heavy damage. Not bad, not exactly the sort of thing I would have, like, gone out of my way for. But at this point, there's no item that, like, hurts you. And the probability of getting, like, a really great drop is fantastic. I'll give you an example. Just take a look at what happens when you stand in the war banner here. I'm kind of just standing there taking damage and laughing at them. So this is a nice thing to get. But the problem is that it only comes up when you level, so it's not that helpful during something like a goblin's fight. Alright, so I don't have a major advantage for going after these guys. Their armor's up. If you kill enemies, there is the possibility that you... there's a possibility that they drop a key card. What I'm going to do here is the bridge is where you fight Providence, so 30 seconds to get to the final boss, basically. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use these key cards, and what I want to get is something from the medical bay. This is going to be a healing table, so I can heal myself partway through the Providence fight. And notice that because I have the foreign fruits, I'm able to heal myself with foreign fruits. Then I'm able to heal myself with the the healing table, and so this gives me a few more options in terms of, like, dodging and kiting and things like that, rather than, you know, previously where I only had foreign fruits, and in some cases I don't, you know, I just simply don't get the foreign fruits. You know, for me, it's one of the reasons why I say foreign fruits is a run saver, because generally you can sort of rely on getting at least one key card and having access to this med bay. And then the next thing I'm going to be getting is Well, you know what? This is a nice little cluster, and I've got resources, so let's go farming. What style upon monsters? So I only have one key card right now. If another one drops, then I'll consider going to the cabin or something like that. But what I want is the rail gun to do extra damage to Providence. So that's going to be in the top right-hand corner in the armory. Storage just has a chest, so if you have a lot of gold, it doesn't hurt. But I'm not really doing so well on gold, and this is just such a nice item to do some damage. So last thing I'm going to worry about is just getting some final boosts. I think these... Mysterious Vial. Increased health regeneration is nice to have because, again, I am going to be doing a lot of kiting during this Providence fight. And then I got a little over 10,000 left to work with, so I'll definitely pick up the 1,000. I'll definitely pick up this. Another Sprouting Egg, not bad, but it does rely on me being outside of combat. And then absolutely nothing. Okay. Waste of money. Everybody! Oh wait, you feel like Chalk should take up a career of reading instructions and strategy books? I'll happily do that for the right fee.
And what exactly is that fee?
A cup of coffee, really. I forgot there's a second layer. Wait, what I want to do here is try and save my foreign fruits, so I'm going to kind of just bounce around like an idiot for 30 seconds. Might give me a chance to get some money and get this last chest. Looks like I don't have any other options. I'm gonna have to stand my ground. The reason why I'm okay with letting some of these guys stand on top of me is I have a lot of items which are, like, they do damage based on receiving damage. So in this particular case, yes, okay, ATG Missile Mark 1 is a great item to get. Basically, it gives a chance, whenever I hit it, it has a possibility of, whenever I fire, it has a possibility of firing a missile. And then there's nothing else I can do with my money, so I'm just going to pick up this drone on my way. And we go on to the final boss fight. And I really love the animations for this boss. So one drawback here is that I have a drone firing on him. He actually has some abilities where you don't want to hit him. The drone does not distinguish between those, so it does mean that this is going to be a little harder than it should be. But I'll just accept it. Actually, what I should be doing is I should be moving him towards the railgun. Or Gauss Cannon, sorry. Okay, what you want to do here is run away from all of this. As soon as he drops this shield, I'm going to fire the cannon at him. And a nice tidy 3,000 damage. So I'm taking a bit of damage here. That's mostly just because I've been pretty careless about interacting with him. And because I can sort of afford to have the cooldown, and I haven't... Basically, when I use an item, I have an ability that fires off these fireworks. It doesn't hurt to use it, but if I were to get to the more intense parts of the fight, I definitely wouldn't want to be using that that healing... healing station. And by the way, I really apologize, Jesse Cole Streamers and Jesse Cole. Obviously, this has been a really, really extended level to not have any kind of direct gameplay. I wasn't really considering that when I recommended this game, but that's actually definitely a defect in my selection of games. So I can only ask your forgiveness at this point.
It was fun to try.
But the music's good. And again, I like the animations of Providence.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're getting past the end of stage one. Ah, you are stronger than you look! And now we're on to the Gilded Worms, or the Hands of Providence. So each of these have their own health pool, and they have two different abilities. One great thing about the commando is that you can fire your sniper rifle like right into the body of one of these things, and it just wrecks them. What I normally do here is I don't use the Gauss Cannon on them because they're fairly straightforward to take out on their own. You just need to keep track of where that targeting is going. and basically just kind of stand and fire and dodge. Sometimes I don't even dodge, but I should. So I should never say never, but out of situations on Providence fights, it's usually not the Gilded Worms that I die on. All right, so he's down. The problem here,
die.
The problem here is that when his shield comes up, if I damage Providence now, it's going to summon a Shadow Providence, which is a real pain in the ass to deal with, to be completely frank. So it would actually be good for this these drones to die. But in this case, I'm going to take advantage of the Gauss Cannon. Oh my god, his shield was up.
Oh.
Alright, that's fine. He's a quarter health, so... But as you can see, this shadow really adds something unpleasant to this fight. I also need to really get rid of the... Okay, you know what? Because I've got shadow up, let's just get some drones. I really need to take down these drones. Oh, shit! This might be it. Fuck! We're dead.
Aww.
Yeah. I should have waited at the... I should have waited at the ledge, let him slash, and then go to the health bar.
Aww.
Oh well.
You
next time.
Killing him, and you totally carried me for 80 minutes. So.
I am so sorry. Nah, we definitely should have won that. That was an easily winnable one, but we got so much stuff. So you should have access to all of this stuff in the. Whew, what a game.
Yeah, the risk is a hardcore game, that's very true. So, like, yeah. In the main menu?
Yes. I suspect we probably don't want to do this again, though.
No, I'm not too fond of it right now.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. Plague? Oh, it's actually really late for you, isn't it?
Not much, too.
And, you don't even lift. Thank you so much for saying that. I'm actually going to take a minute to, while we're waiting, I'm going to turn on the music and I'm going to just take a minute to read out chat. Do we still want to do something co-op?
Yes.
Okay. Actually, I'm just gonna mute myself for you so your chat doesn't have to listen to me reading my chat.
Oh, okay.
Well, I mean, unless you want it, but I don't know if it'll be distracting or not.
I can mute you if I need to.
Okay. Joshy Man has said that Risk is great, slightly different game from Risk of Rain. Joshy says, no, I can't die. Turns out I can. Jesse needs me. Not so true. Endorse, God, banana food is so much better than bananas, specifically banana bread and banana pudding. And your mom mailed you banana bread. Thank you, Endorse. By the way, guys, Endorse is a donor today. 26 American dollars, which is like 3,985 Canadian. and I'll actually just say this, so it was officially written as Akadak donated $26. Howdy, System Shock. It's Endor's birthday. Have money and stuff. And this is actually the thing I really didn't properly appreciate. Endor's 12, thank you so much for donating on your birthday. And happy birthday to you, my friend. I felt like I registered it at the time and I wanted to say happy birthday to you. And then the rails fell off on that game. So please do not take that as disinterest. I definitely appreciate you, again, being such a friend of the stream and hanging out so often, and especially donating on a day where you should be receiving the gift. So the fact that you're hanging out is certainly the best gift that I could have asked. I hope it was a wonderful day for you, and looking forward to hopefully entertaining you for the time. Unvar also agrees with this banana business, although banana candy is awful in most cases. Endors didn't know that banana candy was a thing. And Joshy Man has informed me that we have banana soda.
Yeah.
Mo for Show said hello. Oh, sorry, we decided on a game. Mofa Show likes to play as the Bandit. Bandit's fun. Stop by the stream to decide whether or not you wanted to play some Risk of Rain. Envoy likes Akrid and Sniper, both really good classes. Bighorn Bison, great, thank you.
Hit it, sweetheart.
And a streamer named a character after you in Darkest Dungeon. He was on Death's Door 7 rounds in a row. What streamer was it, Endors, if you don't mind me asking? Joshy Man says, keep wanking. Thank you. How's your health? It's at zero currently. Joshy Man says, I'm as cool as his beer, which I'm assuming means that you're probably having room temperature beer. Oh, Ponce, where are the good old-fashioned American fruits? I'm sorry you saw this terrible... would have lived if those fruits had been American. All right, I think I'm catching up with everybody. Ponce, thank you so much for still hanging out. You know what? I didn't give Ponce due credit. You know what, next time we play this, I think you should stop by, and play, play with us. Richard Hammer was the streamer. Maybe if I exit, the negative will go away. There's an underscore in there, now that you think about it. And where in Canada am I located? I am located in BC, West Coast. All right, we're changing up games, guys. I know what I want to do, and I'm going to talk to the m'lady about it. How you doing tonight, Ponce, by the way? Well, I mean, Jessie Quill was, this is basically, effectively the first time that she's played, so. We have room for all kinds.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
You are hosting me.
I am. I am done casting, but I will still continue to co-cast and game. I told everyone to go hang out with you, so.
I'm really looking forward to this then.
Oh, so, good. Oh my god, I can take off my shirt and I can turn off my light. Oh, I'm so excited.
Okay, so first of all, I need to turn off the. I need to turn off your host of me. Where the hell is it?
Oh, sorry. Hello.
Alright. Everybody's looking at a blank screen. Hello, Jessie Quill viewers. I'm System Chalk. And I'm currently just registering Jessie Quill talking about taking off her shirt and trying to maintain composure. So forgive me if I just bullshit for the next couple of minutes.
Hello, everyone from the collective. My name is Jessie Quill, and I am being featured over on System Chalk's channel right now. I hope you all are going to have a lovely night because I really enjoy hanging out with this amazing broadcaster. You totally carried me so hardcore through Risk of Rain, and your ability to have such command over the game's mechanics and explaining what you were doing and what your plan was so superb. I was so proud of the progress that you've displayed right then and there of what kind of caster you are. Not saying that you did not have those sort of attributes already, but I think just the more often you cast, the stronger your strengths get. So
Okay, so Elkanu is talking about making me blush with compliments. I am absolutely a shade of scarlet right now. That was amazing.
You're very welcome.
Thank you. Oh, Akadak, thank you so much for that host. Guys, okay, so I know I do this all the time. So you all know Jesse Quill already.
Hello.
And Akadak just hosted us for three people. Akadak is an absolutely wondering... Oh, sorry, is an absolutely wonderful caster and a great guy to hang out with. He's one of the few people on Twitch I've had a chance to meet. One of the drawbacks is I am a student, and so it's not always easy for me to do things like make it out to PAX and you know, engage in sort of the meat space aspects of Twitch. And I'm going to be trying for it, right? At some point, I mean, right now, I sort of committed to try and make a con this year, if I could. And I mean, I'll make the money work. I mean, that normally sort of sorts itself out if I can think sensibly about it. But a big thing about it is finding the time, because most of the time these cons come up during my... like during my exam times. But I mean, I think it's really worth just taking a minute here to see some of the people who are hosting us right now. We've got Rithronir, who is a member of Team Panda. We've got Elkanu, who I cannot stress enough is a really, really wonderful caster. He streams in French, which I know makes a lot of people ignore it, but if you just watch him, he has a great command. He's wonderful comedic timing, and he has a really, really good stable of games that he plays, which is a lot of fun. Like, I've always enjoyed being there, even though my French is quite poor. And then I save, of course, the biggest influences for last, Jesse Quill, who has been, from the very start, and a tremendous support. In fact, as I found out just recently, it wasn't just that, you know, she was one of the mods on the application, but apparently the one assigned to my application. And so again, if you want the reason why I'm a member of Team Panda, she's it. She has been there from more or less the start. And, I mean, has done so much to, you know, to support me, get me to the place where I am, and I am left really trying to merit the attention and the care that she's given, because I think she's an absolutely wonderful caster, and you all absolutely know that. Finally, of course, we have Akadak, and the big thing that I want to point out with him is that he's an amazing supporter of many great streamers. He is really one of those people who makes sure that we continue to have content available to us, that he's giving the people those kinds of encouragement, financial, emotional. He's the guy who will host you. He's the guy who will absolutely advocate for a stream when it's one that he believes in. And again, as I said, I got a chance to meet him at EXP Bar, and is every bit as gracious in person as he is virtually. So I know you guys came here for some gameplay, so I'm not gonna take too much longer on this, but I really wanted to take a minute and just let you know about the people behind this, and especially this wonderful lady that I'm going to be co-casting with. It's Jesse Quill, one of the finest streamers on Twitch.tv, somebody who has constantly given me support, entertains the masses on a regular basis, and continues to outdo herself every time she hits that start streaming button. So for those of you who are not following any one of these four individuals, be sure to hit that button. Shall we play some Saints Row?
Yeah.
Let me just change the title. I'm trying to open the game. For some reason, it doesn't want to do it directly from your invite, so just a second. I hope the music isn't too loud for you guys. I'll shut it off when we're in the game.
How are you sending this?
I'm sorry?
Obi-Wan said I need to wear a mask. My son keeps sneezing in my face. And I said, your son stopped being so rude.
Ah. Okay, so I don't know why my screen is visible. Nope, it is working as intended. Rage Panda Pajamas!
Hi, Rage Panda Pajamas.
Rage, I am your biggest secret fan. I cannot remember the last time I've actually been in your channel and said hi. I've been watching you on at school a lot, but guys, Rage Panda Pajamas is actually a fairly new a fairly new addition to Team Panda. Wait a minute, is this a raid? Oh no, it's all just Clara emotes. But yeah, just because I haven't said hi, I want to take a minute and let you guys know about some of the new members who I don't get a chance to shout out as often. Why is it this damn game?
Did you try in windowed mode?
Oh, weird. Apparently it's picking Google Chrome rather than...
It happens, yeah.
Lovely lad, I definitely am not doing high school. But if you want to trade homework, let me know. Oh, just I'm saying to Lovely Lad, if he ever wants to trade homework, I'll...
Oh no, I laughed, sorry.
Oh, sorry. Why? I think I should just... It's not letting me pick Saints Row in windowed mode either, so I think maybe I'll just do a desktop capture.
Yeah, desktop capture can work, I guess. I
hope you guys like Electro Swing. Oh, wait a minute, but I'm...
It works
okay.
For me.
Bizarre. So in this case, it just let me do game capture again. I won't question it. I'll just make sure that I have the right resolution, and,
By the way, everyone, I don't know if you noticed, but our friend here, System Chalk, has reached over 600 followers, which is a pretty awesome milestone, in my opinion.
Well, that is in a very large part to people like Jesse Quill, Akadak, Rage Panda Pajamas, Weebro. Who else do we have here? You know, I think I'm inevitably going to wind up leaving people out if I have to do this all by memory, but it is definitely you good people, both the people who, you know, take the time to stop and watch the channel, people who kind of tolerate this sort of stuff happening, right? Like, right now the game is not in a very playable state, and, you know, dealing kind of with this just stuff that everybody... you know, this is inevitably going to happen to streamers, right? There's no way of getting around it. But the fact that you guys are, you know, sticking with us means a lot. And I, seeing a number like 600, I mean, in some cases, I definitely don't want to forget the people who got me here. But I also definitely appreciate the people who have come along as well. Oh, are you kidding me?
What's wrong?
I think I got it. I just need to quit out one more time. But yeah, I mean, all of you guys coming in, consistently watching the stream, and dropping that follow button, telling your friends about the stream, retweeting, all of this stuff means a lot. So we talk about milestones and things like that, but it is, in the end, a lot of you people who do it. And of course, Yip is here. Yip is the one who I was podcasting with at the very beginning. So tonight's been a really great night for being in touch with some really wonderful people who have given me the support to get me to that number. So I definitely want to say thank you for that.
Well, lovely lad, when you put your TV onto the hentai folder that you have on your desktop, it makes sense that every time you look up, all you see are anime people. Sorry.
Not a problem. I will. So for those of you who didn't see Jessie Quill on the podcast or don't have a chance to watch her that much, Jessie Quill is probably at her best when she's savage. I think there's something about her wit and basically just completely cutting a guy off at the knees, as long as it isn't me. that's positively magical.
Well, thank you very much for that high praise.
Guess what? We are ready to do all the thefts.
Great. Again?
Did you send the invite?
I did. Want me to invite you again?
Oh, you know what? It might be because my Steam overlay is disabled. Okay. One more second and then we'll be ready to do all of the... Man, this is really irritating. I remember it was difficult to set up last time we did this as well.
Came invite sent to System Chalk.
Excellent. And now it's launching.
Yep, I love how seriously you're taking this app thing. Like, you're actually thinking about really great questions that I was actually having concerns about, too.
Look at all you IT people. You're smarts.
It's not IT to be able to suss out that sort of thought process and brainstorming.
Rage is either lewd or rude. You found your new home.
Yeah, really.
WTF game. Gonna get one more invite, please.
Yeah, you see, we had to down cut on... Okay, well, first off, stop dying.
Yeah. I'm so outraged by this game.
You have been invited.
Excellent. Oh my god, I don't remember which one. I think it's this autosave?
I guess? I mean...
Yeah, I hope it's the right guy.
Yeah, it's that autosave. We were at like 3%.
Okay, good.
A player with an ID with unsupported characters. These characters will now be underscore. Okay.
I've got my my fancy ass bowler hat. I mean, look at this, guys. Look at this. Eh? Eh? Actually, it looks a little crappy. No, this is all right.
Your guy looks great. Have fun, Rage Pajama. Or Rage Panda Pajama, sorry.
Call the boyfriend. Ah, hello, my lady.
Hi. I forgot how weird I made this character. Naked like with a beard.
Yeah, looks like we make a good team.
I guess so. Ooh, I like that car.
Shall we travel together?
Yes.
before this man beats me to death with
you.
I guess we need to go on a mission, huh?
Sure. I don't know if I have to control it or if you can. Do you know?
I don't even remember. All right. We've got Pierce, Tammy, Andy, and Jimmy.
Oops. Sorry. Main quest stuff, I guess.
Okay, Pierce.
Just kind of go through the main quest.
Sounds good. Yeah, so... I hope that means we, bro. Tell him we expect him to be in the channel, actually. And then you can have your conversation in public.
Right. You're not ashamed of anything, are you? Like, no, it's just everyone can know everyone's business. That's how this works, right?
Yeah.
Why would you expect privacy? That's so weird. Sorry.
What's the plan? The Saints will be downstairs until you can unlock the elevator for them to come up.
Wait. If I can't go up, then how? Oh. Right, penthouses.
That's right. Meet me at the airport.
The real question is, why would anybody travel in the correct lane?
That doesn't make any sense either. I mean, the opposite lane is always so much faster.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it feels like to me, at least. Oh, wow.
My bad.
People say women are bad drivers.
It's only because there's a woman in the car that this driving is bad.
Well, I'm sorry that my outfit distracts you, or lack thereof.
It's a mighty, mighty handsome birthday suit, if I may say.
Thank you. I grew it myself.
I guess we need to turn, huh?
Probably helpful.
I didn't even catch what we're supposed to do on this mission. I'm just enjoying the music.
You missed a turn.
I didn't miss a turn. This looked faster. The shortest distance between two objects is a straight line.
All right. Well.
There we go. Like a glove.
Just like OJ's glove. Oh my goodness. Well, there we go.
We got there in one piece and with like 10 less viewers. Oh wait, wasn't this the mission where you like fell to your death?
Yes, over and over again. I think this is why we ended.
I thought we got through this though.
Well, we'll find out, I guess, right?
What you thinking? Some asshole is in my pool.
The crew's ready downstairs. Say the word.
You have no privacy. Privacy is overrated. I don't know if I believe that. Privacy is one of the most sacred things that people have.
All right, you're clear.
Okay, I don't.
How do I agree to this shit?
Yeah, you just kind of got thrown off to the.
I got thrown off to the left, but this time I actually beat it.
Well, I'll just have a conversation here if you don't mind.
I'll get the elevator code and let you up soon.
Just give the word, boss.
Oh, hey there.
Hello.
I grab the lieutenant.
Hello. How do I fight? Okay.
What's the code to the freight elevator?
Go to hell. Fine, code's 3131. Just watch the jack.
Apparently, I have weapons. I just don't remember how to get them. Oh.
Remember, it's very important that we don't hit the near naked ladies.
No, except they are the ones that are fighting us.
Oh no! Those ones I'm okay. I'm okay with. I'm thinking the ones in swimsuits.
Ah, I see. Of course. Why would we hurt the ladies? That just sounds like the most idiotic thing to do.
My ability to protect them through not shooting them gets me like at least 2 friendship tokens.
Right. And there's a discount because this is your penthouse, so you only have to pay like 10%.
Wow. The crew's gonna love this place.
Hang on, I gotta go and consult my econ text to figure out the angle.
What problems can't you solve?
Looks like you found the grenades.
So have you played this game? I forget.
Yeah, I've played it through to completion.
We talked about that. We both did 100% in this game.
Yeah, the final sequence is absolutely hysterical.
Mm-hmm.
Where the hell is this basement? I found the shower, if you want to.
Oh, okay, well, let's go do that instead. Fuck this.
See you guys.
So, you know, the grand area to the right underneath the stairs, basically.
Okay.
But
party crashing time.
We're coming up. Keep the door clear.
Oh, what's up?
Nice try.
Oh yeah, Jesse, I absolutely love this Kanye West album too. I like Kanye West in general. I think he's a wonderful artist. And yeah, he might be a little pretentious or full of himself occasionally, but for the most part, I think he's pretty badass.
Yeah, I mean, again, it's this weird sense of like quote-unquote fairness that people have, is like it's possible for people who have wretched personalities to actually still be capable of making good music.
Right. And even though like people say that he has like a bad personality or attitude, I don't think so. It's part of the persona that he lets off as an artist. He says, yeah, I'm like Jesus or whatever he says, however he pronounces it. Like the Jesus and the Lord of music and rap and hip hop and everything. And it's like, yeah, he might actually believe that, but he's fucking good at what he does. So let him go ahead and believe that, because he sells platinum hits and everything like that over and over again. Like, he cares a lot, not only about the lyrics that he has, but the process of making music videos and his persona that he gives off in public. So, eh. Clear out Morningstar, so we have to get rid of more room.
Yeah, where the hell are they?
I think we got most of them. Okay, yeah. Shandy just updated us.
Isn't that fun?
Uh-oh.
I'll ask him how to disarm that thing.
Uh-oh.
I guess we each get a helicopter for ourselves.
I guess so. That's cool. I'm glad that this game has a lot of forethought for co-op. Mm. Alright, let's not crash into buildings. Exactly, Ak. And for the most part, I think if you like really pay attention to what he says and does, you can kind of tell that he's kind of just doing it for the appearances, not that he actually believes it. It's his entertainer mask. And as someone who likes to entertain, I can respect it. I'm not as eccentric or method as he is and many other entertainers, but I could still respect it personally.
I believe Ak Akadak can confirm I as much as a pre-apic, foul-mouthed, ignorant twerp in person as I am on stream.
Lovely to know.
Rockets.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god!
Who isn't cocky? I mean, either you are cocky or you're getting cocky. So, either way, we're all surrounded by cocks.
I want to make a small commonplace book full of quotes like that.
I really like have the weirdest advice sometimes. I love it.
Looks like these things are on a I am gonna beat the crap out of this lieutenant.
Once I catch him, you'll get your codes.
Nope. No excuse codes. Me. Excuse me. I'm just trying to. Thanks.
Green, blue, and black.
Well, that's original. Here's a problem. Everyone out of my way!
How do I defuse the bomb?
The red wire. Cut the red wire.
Good boy.
At least give me a challenge.
Damn, I'm good.
Where's that gun?
Testicular manslaughter.
Testicular manslaughter, best manslaughter. I guess I need to kill this guy, huh? 2 points!
Red Shandy.
Bye, yep, good luck with shoveling. Oh, well, Pie of Reckoning, thank you so much for volunteering that super personal information.
Maddie, there's nothing to worry about.
My thoughts exactly, Mr. Kilbane. The Saints are no more than a white noise of empty sights.
With respect, sir.
Sorry, I'm enjoying the last of my dinner.
I'd say it's fine. Empty is no longer applicable.
Have a good shovel, yep. Thank you for streaming with me. Never mind the stream I'm doing. I had a lot of fun playing Warframe with you.
Yip was someone who just talked a second ago. Joshy, why are you being so silly? You're
That's
lying.
One thing you think you hate people most about you is you're super TMI and you don't give, I don't know if it's fuck or shit about what you say. Don't worry, lovely lad, I hate you for other reasons.
Something I think people hate most about you, super too much of a chat. Oh, okay, yeah. I used to be like that. I used to share way too much information and I realized that it caused way too much stress and drama, and so now I kind of just, I might share a little bit more liberally than I probably should sometimes, but I'm very particular about the people that I share with in general. So basically, once I befriend someone, they get to literally hear my life story maybe like 3 times in a row until it finally sticks or something.
So when do I get to hear this life story?
I don't know. Do you think you'll be able to stick around and actually listen to it?
I guess
wow.
I'll have to try.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
I reckon, do I hate you? I don't know. I guess some more storyline missions, right?
Yes, please.
And you know what, lovey lad? I bet you are just dying to tell people why. And I was gonna say, don't. Prove you can. And you already disappointed me.
Check it out, boss. What's up? Since this used to be a syndicate crib, thought I'd poke around and see what they left behind.
All right, so what am I looking at?
Safety deposit.
Give me a moment, please.
Don't you want to know
of course.
What it is they all got locked up?
The syndicate will know we have the keys. They'll be waiting for us to make a move.
Well, I guess then you better watch my back.
All right, let's go.
Oh, So, chat, how's it going? Am I from the playing card clan from the Batman series? I did not know such a clan existed, Endors. But I love the fact that there is one. If you can send me some, like info on it, I'd love to see it. Josh, you might really like to try hearing this whole story. It's a really interesting story, from what I hear. Joshy Man has learned to share as little about your personal life with your parents as possible. Yeah. Pie of Reckoning is doing well. Had a burger with sweet chili sauce on it. Oh, very nice. And Akadak is eating pizza. I too would like to eat pizza. told them, I bet a female you like, she was too old, too this, too that, or slut or whore, some other derogatory term. I mean, that's a shame that that's how they're... I mean, I... So, obviously, parents are... They're going to be their own quantity, right? There's not a whole lot that I can... Oh, nice. Thank you, Endors. I mean, there's not a whole lot that I can do to sort of change that, right? I'm not entirely sure how I, you know, how I solve the parent equation. But, I mean, in the end, I think the biggest thing is that, you know, a parent can sort of say, it's like, okay, well, I'm going to live in this illusion that the kid is, you know, my kid is always going to be a kid, that I'm always going to be able to sort of decide what's best for them. And I'm going to, you know, steer the sort of affections that they have for people and things like that. And in the end, what happens is that's where you get sort of this like very empty kind of rebellion, and the kids wind up usually making very bad decisions for themselves. Sorry guys, I dropped my wallet. And I know I really need my wallet to play this game. So in this, like in this situation, it's one that doesn't serve the long-term interests of the parents anyway. Hey, playlist. Sorry we're on the pause screen right now. My co-caster, Jesse Quill, is actually sounds like he's come back. Maybe? Okay. But yeah, so I mean, in the end, it's not like the parents are going to... Like, it's an illusion that they're going to maintain control. It's just a question in terms of how long they're going to be able to do that. And the difference here is you can have, you know, an honest discussion with, you know, a son or daughter and... You know, treat them as their own person, as somebody who is capable of making decisions, and, you know, give them advice, give them guidance, but not try to enforce. Or you can do the stuff like what I'm reading from Joshy Man, which is just, you know, rip into everything. Nothing's ever good enough. And I mean, what do you expect? Like, do you really expect that people are going to follow somebody who's constantly negative like that? So, I mean, I don't know. It's... I'm always kind of, I don't know if I should say surprised or just I've come to, you know, just think a little bit more about the sorts of things that people do, you know, like where they try to do it either with good intentions or just what they're trying to accomplish by doing a certain kind of what I would consider to be a hurtful behavior, what the end result is and why something that from, you know, my perspective, something from sort of an outside view, seems to be so obviously harmful. Something that, you know, in micro, I'd maybe call a strictly dominated strategy, one in which all other possibilities are better. Why people so commonly do that? I mean, you can always say it's like, you know, people's emotions get ahead of them and, you know, they're not thinking straight or something like that. But I mean, do you really want to just boil down all of the bad things that people do to each other? It's like they aren't thinking straight. I mean, it doesn't really give us a whole lot of action. It's actually why we talked in Gabriel Knight previously. We had a conversation about ethics. We kind of presented three different ethical systems. We talked about deontology, virtue ethics, and consequentialism. And the idea here is like none of these are going to give you a direct single answer. I mean, some people do find them satisfactory, but generally I consider, you know, there's a reason why there's a debate between these and other ethical systems. Because they, you know, they give you one piece of the puzzle, and then there's maybe some other part that's maybe held on to a little bit weaker. And, I think because we have this tendency to, you know, do things that in the end are not in our interest. I mean, this is almost a Platonic line that we're taking here, right? Is that people don't do bad things willingly. They do so out of ignorance. I'm not entirely sure I entirely believe that, but just this idea that people seem so ready to engage in what would be hurtful behavior to themselves or loved ones in the name of sort of some short-term goal that ultimately isn't served by that action. It's always, I don't know, I think it's a bit of a shame. And I think one of the reasons why I become very interested in ethical questions and specifically meta-ethics, because it really gets to that heart of what is the right, what is the good, you know, how do we come up with a criteria for determining whether an action was right or good. You know,
I would never want to belong to
Oh, thank you so much, Bustopher.
Have someone like me for a member.
I mean, in the end, these questions really interest me because I'd like to think that they sort of have a means of sort of navigating some of these troubled waters. Like, you know, I'm assuming, you know, it's very common to hear that parents are maybe a little bit too overprotective of their kids, especially when it comes to dating or romance or sex or whatever you want to call it and whatever the case may be. Clearly parents love their children. Clearly they want what's best for them. And yet a lot of these stories that I hear sometimes become, you know, a hurtful action being performed, whether, you know, they thought that was the consequence in the end. And again, I think there's more to it than just, you know, saying people aren't thinking straight. I really think that we can do better and we can come up with a way of talking about these that isn't just immediately attributing everything we can't explain down to people are weird. And Joshi Man says it isn't solely on his parents, but you've been burned so many times that you don't know if you can have a healthy long-term relationship. Anymore. Oh, that's not true, Joshi Man. I mean, here's the thing, right? The experiences that we have are going to shape us to who we are today. But in the end, how we choose to respond to them is what matters, right? The past is a sunk cost, right? And I realize that it can be very, very difficult at times to get over what's happened to you before. But in the end, this is actually something I had to teach my students this previous week and the week before. It's this idea of sort of opportunity costs and trying to think about what your next step is. And a lot of students would have these strategies where, you know, they would sort of look at the total cost and like they would say, you know, looking at the past, like, so the idea here is like, let's say nothing has happened before and I have an offer where somebody says, you know, you can get a $20 bill with a 50% probability either way. So, you know, you flip a coin and you get the $20 bill. Or I can work for an hour and get $5. Now, anybody who knows a little bit of probability knows that the expected value of that $20 bill is going to be $10. You know, you weight the probability, and I'm assuming risk-neutral preferences here. You know, you weight the probability of finding the $20 bill, which is 10, once you, you know, multiply it by the 1/2, and then zero, the state of the world where you don't find the bill, and it's zero. So the expected value is 10. Right? This is what you value this uncertain probability, or this uncertain prospect of getting this $20 bill. And you compare that to your option of getting a $5 bill, your ability to get this to work. And if I said to all of you, you know, do you want to get $10 or do you want $5? You'd all say 10, right? Now again, it's a probabilistic statement that I'm making about the 10, but we've already accounted, like, this $10 value we say is once we've factored in the fact that this, there's some uncertainty, we say that this is worth 10 to us here. Now what was interesting is all the students would get this right when we had it at, you know, the first time people played this game. And then we asked them, okay, so if you've been searching for 5 hours, would you still look for that bill? Now, the equation doesn't change. And in the problem, we said that the probability doesn't change. So even if you've like reduced your bed to splinters, you've searched your fridge, like everything in your apartment has been thoroughly searched, it's still an even probability of finding that bill and not. And yet the fact that we said that people had searched for 5 hours, they changed their answer. They said that they would rather go for the $5 because they're like, you know, okay, well, you know, I've already lost, you know, 25, in terms of these foregone wages, looking for a bill that I haven't found. But the right way to think about it is saying that I've already lost this money, right? I've already lost 25. If I find the bill, it's, you know, my loss becomes 15. And if I work, my loss becomes 20, right? You can reduce your loss by more by searching for that $20 bill. And so the answer doesn't change. And yet the fact that people dwell a lot on sunk costs, or in this case, Joshi Man, you know, where you're talking about your history, it's tough, right? I know this myself. But it's very important to acknowledge that, you know, you are the person who you are today, that those past experiences have informed who you are, but ultimately you are going to be shaped. This is your opportunity to be somebody different, to respond a little bit differently. And again, I mean, when it comes to the opposite sex, this is something that you can't control, right? It may be that somebody isn't interested or it's not the right time for the two of you. There are a lot of reasons why things can't turn out between two people. But I would definitely not fall into that trap of thinking that you can't have a long-term relationship with anybody. Again, you don't want to mistake the sunk costs, your past experience, and draw some inference about how it's just going to be the same way forever. Because in the end, I don't think you're giving yourself enough credit that that one day you'll become the sort of person who, you know, who can maintain a healthy relationship and find somebody who values them as well. So
that was an absolutely wonderful way to answer that. Seriously, you had great examples and everything and
Thank you.
Data and theories to back it up.
I know you were here quite some time ago, but the TA in me is, you know how I am.
I loved it.
Okay, thank you. I guess we should continue another, on with it. Oh, sorry?
Sure. Another thing I would add, just really quick, is I think it's also important to just kind of take things one day at a time and don't focus on what could be or what should be, but more of like just enjoy the moments that you have right then and there and try not to hyper-focus on things that you can't control or things that you really shouldn't worry about because they're out of your control, such as, well, yeah, I'm talking to this girl and it's kind of nice, but what if she doesn't want to date fully? Like, what if we just talk and like flirt? That's okay. Just enjoy that little puppy love thing. Or if, oh my God, I want her to meet my parents, but what if my parents hate her? Well, you know, you'll eventually meet one day, but try not to force it and just go with the flow of things. Yeah.
Even if the moment you want to take advantage of is just 10 seconds, still 10 seconds you didn't have before. Shall we resume?
Sure.
All right. Oh, it looks like you're paused as well.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm gonna go in, open the safety deposit box.
To whoever PM'd me, what do you think that last comment was about?
Fuck no.
I like where this is going.
Just be ready when I come
out.
Be ready, all right.
I don't know what you mean. I don't remember what your last comment is.
Oh.
All right, I'm coming out now.
Thank you for identifying yourself.
I'll watch you. Did we get some good shit?
No, I was just trying to help clarify.
Ah, gotcha.
Still think I'm just a pretty face.
Just being a good co-oper.
Excellent.
Oh, be careful.
My bad. I mean, looking at this figure beside me, it's making things real hard on me.
My character looks amazing, alright? Don't hate.
I'm not hating. This is fantastic.
To my loins. Oh.
By the way, I absolutely love this line from my character. That gets the blood pumping. To my loins!
I think that's just what he says when he looks at me, right?
Or when he checks his iPad.
Rude. I'm trying, all right? Just because I don't get 100% accuracy does not mean that I'm not good.
Is the game giving you salt?
Yeah. Are you going to hit these assholes or what? Wow, okay.
Oh, weird. You're getting different dialogue than I am.
Mm-hmm. Don't let these assholes get too close. They're blocking the road.
That's right!
Hey, nice. Perfect unison. I think Ovid had something to say about that, too.
Yeah. I'll set up and be waiting. It makes a lot of sense. I mean, that's just the perfect end to a perfect experience. Oh, are we good? Oh, okay.
I'm about to leap off of a building.
Where is that tied to my character, by the way?
I was about to ask the same question. Oh, Jesus. I have to shoot out the driver?
Yeah.
Damn it.
God, I'm not a good sniper at all.
That wasn't much of a challenge.
Wrapped around the pews? Ew, Joshy man.
What? Where did this come from?
Where is my tethering?
Oh, Jesus Christ. That would be so painful.
Right? Like, no, I'm fine, thanks. I'd rather it be my thigh or something.
Yeah, it's like, do you need, like, a special conditioner to fortify them to do that? Like,
it's to be, like, steel wool, basically. Run, Pierce, run!
Oh god, I used to be really good at this sniping stuff.
Getting old. Gonna have to retire.
Getting caffeinated.
Caffeinated?
My aim's twitchy.
Complete.
Joshy man, you got any material?
Yeah, if you'd love to share, our Snapchats are our respective names, so.
M'lady?
Hello.
I love that sidelong glance your character's giving me. Oh, not anymore, but. more storyline missions?
Mm-hmm.
Trafficking.
The thought of being hung by anything is awful. Maybe we should do a little
advertising around town. Well, I mean, I can say that being hung isn't the worst thing in the world that can happen to you.
Well, not everyone can be as well endowed as you.
Wait a minute, Joshua man, to who?
Well, this is your channel, so.
I'm gonna get one of my cars.
Wow, okay, whatever.
No, this is all about, this is all about me smashing up a beautiful car.
Lovely lad, how do you not understand that? Aw, Josh, he has such respect and loyalty to you.
Okay, I'm checking, Joshy.
Let's cut right to the heart of this shit. Hit the Morningstar territory.
Oh, well, you know which codes are
theirs. Should you send one to every member of Team Panda? Right, I'm the only member of Team Panda you need to worry about, Joshy. What happened to this cast? I used to be all about, like, history and, like...
sorry,
you were going to say?
I'll leave.
don't you dare. Sorry, you were going to say something.
I said, well, if you're the only member, I think we need to do some empirical research to make sure that that's actually true. We need to compare everyone's assets. Too easy.
Just my whole time. You really hate that car. By the way, where do you keep the ammo?
Asking right? For a yeah, friend. Where do I keep the guns? Hello? How do I... Okay.
Who are you?
Hi, Kill Bandit. How are you? I'm slow, Jesse. Smart, but slow. Ah. Okay. I'm very confused. What were we... You just had to wait?
Okay. We just need to do deals, so. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, I'm driving? Fuck no. Oh, hello, helicopter.
You gonna get in?
I'm going to murder the crap out of this sniper. I'm going to attempt. Okay, now I am almost dead. Please let me in the car.
Hi, you're the one who's not getting in the car.
Hey, eyes open.
This driving is disgraceful. Never mind. We've actually crashed into something now. It's like, what kind of drive? Oh, hello.
Hello, lady.
So, I've got this cough. She's dressed as a nurse. Come on. Oh, hello, my lady. Got some high-end fashion right here. Wankers! Wait a minute. Give you some Pringles and you'll wear anything? Eh, you know what? I already got one of these over here.
That wasn't much of a challenge.
Alright, chat. How the hell are you? I'm killing things. I don't have anything original to say at this point. Well, that's not entirely true. I've got things I can say to my pilot.
Let's pick this up another time. Mm-hmm. Gotta work on my technique.
Sounds good to me. Illinois Syndicate.
But I don't want to ignore you fine people. Playing Warframe and killing things. Well, I'm glad we had that kind of effect.
Mario Maker. I need to get that.
I assure you, lovely lad, you are not overly charming. I hope that makes you feel better.
Thanks for the ride.
Yes, I will absolutely agree with that sentiment.
Would you like to listen to classical music in my new car, my lady?
Of course. That gives you, like, at least half a friendship token.
Sweet.
Unfortunately, in 2016, we don't use tokens anymore. We use another type of currency that you need to convert from tokens. And you can't know exactly what the name of that currency is until you earn enough tokens in the first place.
Sacre bleu.
You want to rob some store?
That'll cause more problems than it's worth. I'm saying we buy one from the Morningstar.
Yeah, because they'll jump.
I'm going to call them smirk tokens.
Smirks. I love smirks.
They can't argue.
Ah!
Wow, that was close. I thought you weren't going to hit anyone in that whole conglomerate of people. Thank God that you did at the very last second.
Yeah. I am a professional driver.
My cutscene is all freaking out.
Going to friendly fire?
Yep. Best thing is, owning it gives us a discount.
I like the sound of that.
How do I purchase?
This
here we go.
Full of businesses and buildings we could snatch up.
Sounds like a way to get the money flowing in.
Right. Though we're going to need Steelport on our side, too. Driving around and see if we got any fancy.
Wait a minute. Find the sex doll.
Oh, yay! I can have the dildo. I'm so excited.
Oh. I forgot that you can actually... You have limited run in this game.
Limited what?
Limited ability to run.
Mm, yeah.
Come on, Joshy man, you know better than to name them. What if you want variety? Assign the name you want at the time. But the thing is, I don't know if this is going to be a hunk or a lady. Hey, we found them, a ladies. Too hot for Twitch. Oh my god, that noise. And now I believe the mission is bugged.
Why is that?
Because it is telling me to acquire a sex doll I have already acquired.
Maybe I need to acquire it.
Okay.
Joshy man, that doesn't sound like a chemistry class at all. Are you sure that's what you were at? Look, I got a toy for you.
And we are entering a car called the Temptress.
Oh my goodness. This cannot be any more perfect. Yes? No?
Oh, we're listening to the... You know, not the first time that's happened to me with a lady in my car.
Really?
I don't have a car.
Oh, that story just gets better and better.
I was going to say, based on my middle school experience...
Do I really want to know?
Oh, that?
I was going to say, it's usually been a lack of chemistry cast.
I don't mean it like that. They're collectible. You're supposed to try and find them all.
This is stupid. No, I'm not even going there. What's the next deed in the
box?
See
you, Pierce.
We already have a new place.
All right, there's not enough room in this.
Some people are paying us.
The Temptress. Sorry, did it wrong. The Temptress.
Uh-oh, we have to go back.
Oh, to get Pierce?
Yeah.
Hasn't given me a warning yet, but... Alright, I guess I'll get a real car. I kind of wanted to keep this one, though.
Ah.
Oh, wait. Where's... Pierce is here, so... Yeah, he stole a police car. He's all good.
Okay.
And we're listening to the heaviest of metals.
Could you stop committing race crimes, please?
This, nothing is racially motivated about this. It's because he made me. It's because he made me pick up a sex toy.
He doesn't think you could get your own. He was just trying to be. He was just trying to be a friend.
All right. As fun as that was, I guess we need to complete the mission.
I suppose. Maybe we can get him onto the roof of our car.
Oh, that would be awesome. Are you getting your own car, I guess?
Yeah.
All right.
So I can take him with me.
I understand my driving causes this effect in people. He's trying to kill me.
Wow, okay, so... Oh, okay, Pierce was shooting. I was like, is this lady shooting at me? But no.
I think taking the cop car triggered a police alert, but whatever.
I didn't take the police car, but I guess he did.
Mm.
Why is this only $100? This doesn't make any sense.
I think it's because it's for a mission.
Yeah. Maybe we should stop by. Oh, police cars are too small too. You're listening to the blood. For three people. But I'll just have it for him. Here's a great single from Black Veil Brides
and speak. It's very important that I listen to pounding techno.
That's the only way that you could do things, right?
Mm. I drive better when I'm listening to.
Oh shit. I love driving in this game so much.
Whee!
Oh, I heard your character say that blood pumping line.
Oh, I got Murder Time Fun Time, but yeah, I am definitely a much bigger fan. I mean, it's because, let's face it, this is a line you'd expect me to say.
Yeah.
That gets the blood pumping to my loins! I believe I have just crashed.
Oh, bitch. I can't get up there. Is wow, that's really interesting, Joshy. Oh, co-player disconnected.
Son of a bitch. All right.
Meh.
Sorry, everybody. Okay, let me catch up with what Joshy Man was saying. Didn't feel the need to study, understood the material. Yeah, see, this is one thing, not to, you know, disrespect anybody in the chat, but this is the one thing I've never really liked, is the boast that you got through a class without trying hard. Because, I mean, if you're doing a first-year class like the one that I'm teaching, it's kind of designed that anybody who has the most basic requirements to enter into university, which is basically showing up to high school and not completely wrecking it, should be able to pass. But what I try to communicate as a TA, and I mean, obviously this is a perspective that I've gained from engaging with these topics a little bit more deeply and, you know, having to teach people them. I think there is something to be said for engaging with material, understanding it well, and also putting in the effort, because there are a lot of people in life who are basically just going to be phoning it in, trying to do the bare minimum, and, you know, move on to what's important to them. And that's, you know, not necessarily bad. Like, obviously nobody else is going to be looking for your interests. But the big thing is that, like, if I'm engaging with you, let's say that you decide to open your own business, I'm not particularly interested in, like, half-done work. I am interested in somebody who understands what they're doing well and will put in the effort, you know, no matter what. And it's a very rare trait, right? I mean, when people leave a job, like, they'll just, you know, not show up. I'm specifically shouting out Jessie Quill, who did actually show up to her job here, by the way.
Thank you.
But yeah, like, there's, you know, the biggest thing that I like to say is that, to me, it's not an indicator of intelligence that somebody didn't have to try hard in a class. It just means that the class was, you know, was too easy. In the end, if you want to do work at the frontier, which is really where the quote-unquote smart people work, then that's going to involve a lot of hard work. That's going to involve not just coming up with, like, first of all, people don't know the right questions on the frontier. That's, you know, why it's so hard to do this kind of research. And then on top of that, you have, once you have a question, once you have a formal way of posing it, you have to do all of that hard work of saying that, you know, some people are going to say, you're wrong, you're stupid to do this. Some people are going to, you know, say, I mean, in econ, the easiest thing that you can raise as a problem is saying, is like, oh, you know, I think your instrument is endogenous. It's a meaningless statement. Everything's fucking endogenous in the models. Like, can you actually come up with a valid criticism of this model? You have to do a lot of very, very hard work to push that frontier out, even by a little small amount. And that has to come from a place of passion and a place of interest. And I know school isn't the best place to do something like that, because in the end, some people just want to get a piece of paper and get a good job. And I understand that. But in the end, you know, there's only so much time that you have in the world. And I would like to think that even if I'm doing a job that I might even think is beneath me, that I can still take pride in the fact that I did it as good as I can. I mean, the time is going to be taken up anyway. So I might as well do it right rather than just, you know, do the minimum amount. It's, again, like, it's a very different way of thinking, and I know it's easy to say, and it's hard to do at the moment, but it's something that I think enriches people. Anyways, sorry, I sermonized again.
No, it's great.
Do I have an invite?
I could send another one. Yeah, okay. I'll send another one.
I understand you may have been occupied.
A little bit. But, it was for a good cause.
Sorry, I just got the invite.
I really enjoy your little breaks of chatting about views of how the world can be... can't join or end the mission. Oh, okay, I guess I have to end the mission. Exit. Okay.
Well, it says the host is busy and has asked me to wait, so I don't mind waiting. I've got material to keep me busy.
Okay. This is some Chuck's joining the game.
Hey, we are in our crib. I believe this... Oh.
You are.
I am in the crib. Now you need another tale so Chalk can sermonize more.
Right? Yeah, I love it. Preacher Chalk.
I guess the one thing I would wish is that whenever you do such chats on your channel, I always feel that you're able to incorporate into the game a little bit better. And in addition, I just think you have a little bit more of a concise way of dealing with it. I also think you just generally have a little bit more empathy. Like, sometimes it, you know, what I say is just kind of like, you're fucking up. Stop doing it wrong. But, yeah, I don't know. I sort of feel... M'lady, your chariot awaits.
Oh, thank you.
Push me, and then just hurt me, till I get my satisfaction.
I appreciate that. I think it's really funny that we both admire the opposite quality in our ability to communicate with others. I really enjoy how you speak for an incredibly... I'd lack for a better word, a long time, and it basically feels like a oral essay, and it's just very
an oral.
God damn.
Sorry.
You're fine.
Going friendly fire?
Yep.
Whereas I think for me, I
like the sound of that.
Do sound bites basically, and I think we both get the point across, and we both get our ideas conveyed. It's just we both do it in different ways, and I just think it's kind of funny that we both admire those traits in the other person, like, because we both just go about it in different ways.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, I suppose the best thing that I can say is I'm glad... Alright, well, I'm not going to be left out of the arms race.
Good thinking.
I'm just going to see if I can do some upgrades as well.
Dildo.
All right, I'm broke now.
Nice. Yeah, Joshy man, I'm the exact same way. There are plenty of times where, like, you know, a caster will come into my channel and be like, oh, go check them out, they were last playing, fuck, I don't even know, and I watched them yesterday. Why don't I have a dildo? I want a dildo.
I have one for you, m'lady.
Oh, how sweet of you. You're such a nice guy. Such a good friend. I can't...
Hear that, chat? This is how you get friendship tokens. Mm-hmm, or mm-hmm. Smirk tokens.
The fuck? I can't get it. I don't understand.
That was easy.
Whatever. I tried. I'm upset now. I guess we should go in the big purple car, honestly, to take Pierce with us.
I may have caused some problems for us.
You only know one female that admits to using dildos. Well, I mean, it's sort of a personal activity. There's no reason to really admit it to anyone unless they want the attention from, hey, look, I touch myself for pleasure. Guess what? Like, most of the world does.
Yeah.
It's not anything special, and people who lie about it either have not done it yet, or... I mean, people who say that they don't are either have not done it yet or are lying about it and are ashamed. And they want to have this certain persona that conveys that they are way too good to pleasure themselves, which doesn't make any sense. Like, it's one of the easiest ways to release so many great natural chemical reactions, like happiness and content and relieve stress. Like, why would you not do it? Just,
man,
I know why people wouldn't, obviously, because of religious upbringing that's pervasive in their thinking and all that, but that's the biggest reason I think people would do it. There's some people who have, like, this weird weird is like a rude word. We mean weird as in not usually normal. Idea of that, well, since everyone else does it, I don't want to do it, sort of thing. And there are some people who are like that are straight edge, which means that they, if they label themselves or not like that, it's just a term that you can use to label people who don't drink or smoke or participate in base, you know, vile, vain vices. I use like every other V word in the dictionary.
That's fine. I'm happy with the alliteration, especially in the V's.
Thanks.
Remember, chat, give the m'lady the right of way.
Jesus. What was I saying? Vain vices or whatever. And sometimes that also includes like not participating in sexual things, personal or with others. So there are definitely people out there who it's not a religious thing. It's more of just a willpower or determination thing. Yeah, self-control.
I mean, in the end, there's I think Twitch demonstrates. I'm really trying to find out how to throw grenades.
Right bumper? Oh, sorry. I don't know what the controller. I mean, you could pause for a moment to look at your
thank
controls.
You, lady.
Mm-hmm. I was with a woman. Touch yourself for pleasure regularly. Yeah, okay. Hold on. Wait, you said I was with a woman, but then you said when we weren't together. I don't understand. Like, are you talking about two different time periods? Like, the first part was later on, and the second part was in the beginning of your talking to her? See, asexual doesn't necessarily mean that you don't have sex. Asexual means that you don't have sexual feelings. And technically, being a demi or sapiosexual means that you don't find people easily physically attractive unless they meet certain criteria. Like I've explained before, sapio is people's intelligence and demi is people's relationship and friendship with you. So there's other terminology as well, but those are technically within the asexual category. And there are some people who are aromantic, which means that they don't like any sort of romance, but they might be super sexual. Or they might be asexual, but they're incredibly romantic, and they have different ways of showing affection for people. Mm. Or attraction. But yeah, I studied a lot of this when I was in university for psychology. I always found it really fascinating because I was a horny little git. Was, that's so funny. Am.
I mean, the big thing is, again, I always like to come back to the individual, right? whenever. So I mean,
Christ, there's so many people. Do you see this? Whenever we talk, spawning.
Yeah, I mean it's fantastic. I just really wish I knew how to fire grenades because I'm running out of bullets.
Let's see. Maybe I can look.
It says like press G to get the next grenade, but I don't know. It doesn't have like a fire for grenade, unfortunately. So.
Oh, like release.
Yeah. Isn't it terrible when you can't release?
God, I bet. it's just, it's so, when you get so frustratingly close, it's ridiculous.
Oh my God.
Sorry.
No worries. I did the same to you, so. I set myself on fire. Just for the sake. Oh wow! I didn't know I had an assault rifle. This is fantastic. I'm gonna kill way more people now.
I'm just gonna like run them over or something. I have no idea. I ran out of so much ammo. Yeah, it is terrible not being able to release. It's ridiculous. Like that's just one of the biggest frustrations in life.
Sorry, I know you said something. I'm just too busy focusing on killing people. We might actually be at the end of this.
Looks like we killed like 100 of them.
That should get them to back off.
Why would they be afraid of friendly fire?
Because we own it. So we got boys.
Oh, hang on. I'm gonna get my fancy car. Ouch. At least it kept my hat.
The important part.
And I have my pounding techno.
It helps me find release.
You know, as much as I really like The Risk of Rain, and we've done a lot of co-op stuff together, I think Saints Row is one of my favorites, because it's, like, this game knows exactly what it is, and it's, I mean, Yip and I were talking about how Warframe is a little bit like a furniture game, kind of like Diablo 3, where, like, you can just sort of grind
furniture
away.
Game.
Yeah, like, you can grind away with some friends and, like, just talk about whatever. It doesn't require like undivided attention to go through runs. Like obviously,
sure.
I'm sort of generalizing, but yeah, the like this is something that, you know, I don't think we're in any terrible fear that we're going to wind up like dead. But we and we're like we're just able to. You know, talk about whatever we want. So, and I think it's one of the nice things because I know, I mean, everybody in chat's already being so generous about this, but I mean, I might as well say, right? You know, we seem to have at least some comparative advantage on talking. and, you know, it's a way we can kind of put this stuff on display. It's a way that we can, you know, get the advantages of,
oops.
You know, well, one, you know, what we do already, and then I suppose whatever benefits from, you know, co-casting, I don't know what you call it, chemistry, synergy, just general standoffishness. but yeah, it's kind of neat to do this in Saints Row, just because, again, it's a game that's, like, it's fun, and it's, like, it's obviously fun the whole way through. It's fast paced, but we can still talk about, you know, anything from philosophy to relationship stuff. Obviously, that's your specialty. And everything in between.
I just read a lot about it, that's all.
Well, I mean, I read that, like, the game book, right? Does that make you an expert?
You mean the original one by Ovid?
Yeah. Ovid, our master, taught us everything we know.
This may be the best idea you've ever had.
Mm. Lovely lad, you said, I imagine there's at least one person in this world who has fetishes for dildos that long. I think that we can narrow that down to, there's one person who's watching this cast right now. Out of the 22 people, someone likes dildos that big. So, never underestimate the horniness of the average human. Wow, okay, chill, sir.
I don't even need to move.
Yeah, I'm doing all the work. Typical. God, this must be so easy co-oping, though. Yeah. Never thought about it like that. Hey, I made people laugh. Oh, never mind. You made people laugh. With your tube. Your floppy tube, apparently.
What? What chat are you reading?
Oh, whoops, sorry. No, when you were moving the top of your tank and it was hitting me, like, tube went up at, like, that 90 degree angle. I don't know if you saw it, but
I definitely saw that.
Okay, just making sure.
Oh, it's Endor's. I should have known. But it's his birthday, so he's allowed to be lewd.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, guys, I did shout out Endor's. Would everybody in chat be so kind as to wish Endor's a happy birthday?
Happy birthday, Endor's! By the way, okay, so I know that you said, like, oh, I don't think I bought that splitter for you. Well, that splitter came in my P.O. box October, like, 1st or something. And I haven't been able to check it because my P.O. box expired, then I went to Australia, and then the holidays hit, and this last past week was the last time that I was able to actually check my P.O. box. So there was a lot of backlog of things, and I'm pretty sure you were the one who got it for me. You just don't remember because it was so long ago. I just kept forgetting to tell you that until now, I guess.
I mean, Endor's, I know that's turned into a little bit of a joke in terms of the way that you do, you credit stuff to Akadak, but I mean, obviously, the support that you've given me is always very much appreciated, but especially when you do that for other casters, especially casters that I watch myself, it really means, as much, if not even more. I mean, there are ways that I, my enjoyment, and in fact, the enjoyment of all the others is enhanced. Because in this case here, right, like, I think Jesse Quill is one of the finest streamers that I have on my list of people who I follow, and she also just gets quite a few more people watching her casts, and so as a result, the effect of something that will enhance her ability to cast really is felt. It has ripple effects above and beyond what above and beyond maybe what people first realize, and it's one of the reasons why I always I still struggle a little bit to process donations, just because in the end I know in the end I kind of need to be a good steward of that money. It's money that could have potentially gone somewhere else. Even if it was, earmarked for streamers, I need to make sure it results in content that's being made that people find fun. Anyways, it's not going to be a full monologue. Just wanted to get that out of the way. By the way, for those of you in chat, who here likes camping?
Like as in the video game?
Oh.
Camping term?
camping spawn point? No. The activity of camping. Outdoors. Well, I suppose you can camp elsewhere, but I only know of camping outdoors. No, Joshy man, keep that coming to me. Sorry. I asked you a question I didn't.
Give more money to Jesse and credit to Ack. I mean, if you want. I personally don't really.
You ready to be a
like the idea of camping. Maybe like, not like sitting on the, or sleeping on the floor or whatever, but the idea of it's sort of romantic in the sense of like, you know, you're out there without any, electronics or...
Oh man, the old lady's about to kick my ass.
Oh Jesus, she slammed the door on you and everything.
Nothing slows me down.
Oh my god!
That's amazing.
She got wrecked. Alright, perfect. I don't think I would be completely happy with being totally camping like inside of a little tent, but maybe like in a cabin or something.
I definitely like camping in little tents.
Really?
And big tents.
Well, I've never done it before, so I guess that's why I'm kind of like afraid of it. But if I went with someone who has a lot of experience with it and knows the area that we're camping in and like knows where to go to get assistance if anything bad happens, then I would totally be fine with it. I probably couldn't do it by myself, especially for the first time. But yeah, it all just depends.
Time to see how the game is played.
In truth, I was just moving towards that to say I'm not a big camping fan. I am a fan of tents.
What kind of tents? Like, do you have a specific brand or type of cloth in mind? Or
Big fan of the toga tent.
I haven't heard of that. Show, that sounds interesting. No one gets to take a break. If you want to stay in the fight, be sure to shoot them. Oh, indoors. That's awesome. I think it would be kind of fun to
pants tents. Joshy man, we're classical people here. We wear togas.
Hi, Jesse.
Welcome to Professor Genki's super epical reality climax. Murder time is fun time, right, Bobby?
You got it, Zach.
Oops. No, I was not supposed to do that. Deadly traps, armed mascots, I forgot if I got money for that hunters, or not. They can win a hefty
pile of cash. This game looks deadly because it is. But it's still probably safer than driving in Steelport.
Our competitor isn't from Steelport this time, Zach. Today we'll be watching the leader of the Saints, the world famous Stillwater Street Gang.
As many times as this former gangbanger has been shot at, blown up, run over, and generally put through hell, this competition probably seems pretty routine.
Routine maybe, but lucrative. You are going to make Professor Genki-sized dollars driving hoes around, that's for sure.
I'm on fire!
They'll go home rich!
I mean, I know you're, We have a present! A present is in the maze!
Very impressive.
This Saints one hell of a competitor.
You seem to be fairly low on health, m'lady.
Oh jeez, I am.
From the fire trap.
People will be talking about this round for a while.
This is really amazing shooting. Saints are gonna own this.
It couldn't last any longer than that.
We have a present. A present is in the maze.
That's some great action.
Money shot, huh?
This thing is doing everything right.
Oh, so what Endors is talking about, Jesse, is that back in October, I got a package that was accredited to you. And so, you know, I put on Twitter and said, thank you. And you replied and said, no, I think it might be Endors. And then Endors replied and said, no, that wasn't me. And I picked it up like at the end of December or something, so I was like, oh, that's weird. But I looked at when it was actually sent, and it said like very early October, and I wasn't able to pick up anything because my PO box expired, so I had to renew it. And then also I went off to Australia, and then holiday season hit, and then I was finally able to pick it up, and it was there. So I guess Endors kind of forgot. But it was very useful because I was able to use it for my Fable broadcasts, and eventually I'll be able to use it for PlayStation 3 broadcasts as well. So yeah, I know, right? I knew it too.
Don't mind me, just enjoying a little bit of a ride.
fun.
Yeah, and thank you, by the way, Akakadak, for...
How did you not see me? Someone better buy me a drink! This ain't doing well.
No one beats a saint!
As I was running over, your character said, "Wow, I love this."
Jesus Christ. But yeah, Akakadak, I was going to say thank you for the $26 donation earlier.
Mm-hmm. You weren't even here and you did it. That's amazing. Oops.
Oh shit, did you start a mission?
I accidentally canceled it.
Go to the Broken Shillelagh.
I'm surprised the Syndicate is still standing after all this shit we've thrown at them.
I don't see a reason to stop.
Not saying we should.
All right. Then see you at the Broken Shillelagh.
Oh man, where's Jesse? Oh, never mind. I'll just follow the police cars.
Running people over and seeing them fly.
You know, there's a side of me that kind of wishes that I could see like your side of the of the action.
Well, maybe if I casted.
Nah, it's fun to.
Beer's cheap.
Sometimes
fun
to
just.
I have
no idea how nice it is to just relax.
Yeah.
I lost my phone.
You lost your phone?
Yeah, I don't know where it went. Oh, I found it. It was on my arm rest of my chair.
I was going to say, you don't mind, maybe just give me your number. I don't mind calling it and helping you out.
Oh, wow. Time
for a stripper. No, Powder's a designer gun store downtown. I saw some of Loren's thugs talking to the owner. There's got to be something there. All right, let's go shopping.
Let's go shopping. To take Pierce with us?
Nope, sorry. Two important people in a tight space. You're a monster.
I didn't mean to.
Here I was trying to write something to somebody, and now I gotta escape the cops. Wait a minute, are we on a mission or what?
I thought we were? I don't know what happened. I guess it was just turning in something, maybe.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Johnny, give me good news.
We're gonna burn Powder to the ground.
That's a little extreme.
See you there.
Johnny, wait. Oh boy.
Oh, my game might have crashed.
Oh, okay. Being disconnected from the host, yeah.
Sorry.
I'm gonna save just in case.
Mm-hmm. Oh god, I haven't saved in forever. Oh shit. You might have to be the one who opens up the game then.
Okay.
Host the game, I mean.
So what I've got here is we've only just begun at 12%. I can't think of any stories for Chalk to lecture us to. I don't think I've invited you before, so I gotta, I just gotta figure myself out for a second.
Sure, take all the time you need to, figure yourself out.
player has an ID with unsupported characters. Oh, it's probably just somebody in my list.
Mm. Oh, that makes sense.
Jesse Quill, best Quill.
Oh, thank you. You guys are very sweet. I guess by you guys, I mean you. Sorry. The rest of you can be as naughty as you like as well.
Hello, chat.
Hello, System Shock.
How's everybody doing tonight?
I am fantastic, thank you for asking.
I believe because we spawned in the same place for one brief moment, I was inside you.
All right, chat. Thank you so much for hanging out. I'm gonna go ahead and say what the fuck and goodbye. You're ridiculous.
Thanks, everybody. Good stream.
System Shock is busy.
Busy? I'm right here.
Yeah, it's just... I'm trying to start a mission. Alright.
Really, chat? You didn't like that?
Shandy, give me good news.
We're gonna burn powder to the ground.
That's probably my reaction to it too.
Shandy, wait. Oh boy.
I'm just gonna take a second here and update a couple of things.
No problem.
He's freaking out over here.
Hmm?
I was going to say, it sounded like somebody's freaking out on my audio.
On your end?
Yeah, oh, I'm like shit. Hearing screaming and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's my character dying. I need to be revived.
Fair enough. I also just heard my Discord go off. There we go.
Entered and left. Ugh, I hate how... Me all tabbing pauses again.
Yeah. All right. Sorry, guys. Brief interlude to upgrade my character and just generally be a pain. Informal cast, best cast. There we go.
Thanks, System Jock.
Wait a minute, I was alt-tabbing the entire time. You were probably getting constantly paused.
No, I'm fine.
Okay, good.
Said, thanks for that upgrade, update thing.
Ah.
Let's see. Where to?
Oh wait, we didn't set start a mission, did we?
That's because I died. Alright, there we go.
Shandy, give me good news.
We're gonna burn powder to the ground.
That's a little extreme.
See you there.
Wow.
That was really close.
I was gonna say I was gonna say we know who wears the pants in this relationship, but that analogy just doesn't really work in this situation.
Not at all.
A lot of people with guns in there. We'll go in the back way.
You don't think the back's guarded? There's like two punks. What about the
dialogue?
Yeah.
Put in your tampons and let's do this.
I love this game so much.
Why can't I use this weapon?
There we go.
Motor time! Bullet time!
Great plan, Shandy.
You said two guys, not my fault.
No, I'm serious. This is my kind of plan.
You know, it's a game we haven't co-opted, but probably would work somewhat well in?
Mm-hmm. What?
XCOM.
You think so?
I don't know. It depends how much you like playing the game.
I don't know if I like it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I know, right? We've talked about this before. Like, I don't think I'm smart enough to do long-term, multi-step strategy games. So that's like, I do enjoy Civ and XCOM to a point, but then like halfway through when you realize, holy fuck, what I did has totally messed up myself, and you basically try to resolve it and then you realize that you can't, and you see how much you've messed up basically. And I know that the only way that you can really do that is practicing or looking up strategies and such, but it's still kind of like, oh. I would absolutely love to try it with you for sure though.
Yeah. I mean, the only problem is that it's competitive. So in this case, you know, by necessity, we would have to be on opposing teams. But that's fine because I make the same mistakes that a normal human does. So in this case, maybe the punishment of games like that will be a little less less intense.
Your screen is frozen.
Oh, damn! Mm-hmm. Sorry, guys.
I didn't notice.
I just need to get to a safe place. It's probably been like that for a while then. I'm really sorry, guys. I might have to quit out. Okay, so it says mission checkpoints aren't safe, so we're probably going to have to go back here, but sorry about this, but I don't have any better solutions other than to quit out.
I think that just goes to show that people don't really care about the game, but more of the conversations.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's like it's probably been like that for a while.
I threw you an invite.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Alexis and Jack would like to join your game. Would you let them? No.
There's you way too many. It's either four huge favors or a gigantic favor now. I think I hit gigantic.
Oh yeah, definitely. Simchak is busy. I think it's because you're in the crib.
Yeah, I'm upgrading my vehicle.
Oh, okay, sure.
Or, as the kids say, pimping my ride.
I don't know if kids say that anymore, but...
The kids say on fleek, right?
Oh, God.
I hate that slang so much.
You hate the word on fleek?
Oh, God, yeah.
Well, fuck you, because my eyebrows are on fleek, all right? And I'm going to say it.
I think it's because there was a conversation my friend of mine, actually, it's the guy who owns EXP, and I were having about how we can't quite figure out the origins of it. Like, it just seems to be a word invented because nobody else could, like, come up with any other words.
Right, I have no idea where that came from.
Yeah, whereas, like, you know, if you think of, like, classic terms, like... I mean, like, nobody has ever really said bad since, like, that... fuck, what's the movie? Like, I don't even know the movie. Like, it's the one that has, like, that power glove scene. I love the power glove, it's so bad. But, like, you can kind of understand where that comes from, right? Or hip.
Hmm.
I don't know. I suppose we're gonna.
What the hell was that?
Just a side mission. Oh, we're not gonna worry about the Syndicate stronghold?
It's confirming the start of it with you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's like a side mission that we could do. The blue. I don't mind canceling it. Okay. Oh, alright. Well, apparently it's canceled, so. This will be quick. Your chariot awaits, m'lady.
I always win my arguments.
God, Constantino, thanks. The stream is on fleek. All right.
See, Constantino, you fell into my trap. I was just looking for a compliment. I now have the validation of Dayute today.
Oh, I think I can only take, like, three more cringy things before I have a piece.
I will be sure to use them well. I actually started one of my lectures that way.
What?
It got the... Well, like, I mean, again, so... I'm going to a bunch of people who are potentially... It's their very first year at university, right? And I'm like the kind of nerd who spent 5 years in school studying economics. So to break tension, I just kind of went up and said, it's like, you know, hello, class. What is on fleek with you today?
I was wondering why he said that. That makes sense.
Nice try.
So.
I'm up for more.
Suffice to say, the lecture was very relaxed after that.
Right.
I didn't even know this is a survival mission. Cool.
System Chuck's fleekness is on fleek. If you had to pick one slang word that people are not allowed to use anymore, what would it be and why?
Oh, man.
I mean, if you have more, go ahead, but...
I mean, so I'll be honest, as much as I like to, like, complain about stuff like this, I feel like, I mean, people should be able to express themselves the way that they want. Like, if they're morons, they're just not going to be able to explain themselves very well, and it will, be revealed through the way that they talk. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't believe that slang words make people dumb. So it's like, why would I, you know, why would I want a restriction on that language? I'm just trying to think of some, like, nasty slang words I could get rid of.
Like hateful, like, words?
Yeah, like, I mean, I don't know if that really counts as slang or just, like, you know, people being dicks. Because I don't think that's where the question was going.
Hmm.
I think the question was designed to make me look like an elitist. And I already am, so... I know, I'm being silly.
Because the next question was going to be, like, if you... What's the one slang word that you can't live without? Like, one that you love using? You just have, like, such a...
Oh, dame. Definitely dame.
Dame? Really?
Not really, but... It
I was about to say, I've never heard you say that, so what the fuck does that mean?
Yeah, I was going to say, like, dame... Dame really needs to come back.
Hmm. Sorry, I had to use that emote because I have it. Leave us the fuck alone.
Okay, the mad grenadier has just set me on fire. You all saw that, chat. I think we're done the survival mission, by the way. Like, right now, we're just straight up killing people.
Oh, okay, whoops.
And I don't have a problem with this. I'm just, you know, I think we should be very clear about our intentions here.
Alright, let's head out and then find another quest.
Oh yeah, as far as quests. Oh, you got it.
Shani, give me good news.
Endors, yeah, I don't like what are those very much, but like when it first came out, it was kind of funny or whatever, but it's just, it's like when people overuse memes or slang or viral hits and stuff, it gets cringy after a while. It's just like, come on, it's not that funny anymore. There's more funny stuff to use now.
You know, actually, I was going to say, I think that's one of the reasons why I have difficulty answering the question of what slang word would you want to get rid of, because in the end, I think that one depends on what the current flavor of the month is. Like,
absolutely.
I dislike overused material.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people with guns in there. We'll go in the back way.
You don't think the back's guarded? There's like two punks. What about the inside, motherfucker?
Dank memes. That's true. I was looking for dank memes.
You know, I will actually say I'm not huge on the term, I'm not huge on the term dank. Like, I get what it's in reference to, right? But
it's,
I don't know.
It's like self-ironic at this point.
Yeah, like, I, even when it first came up, I'm kind of like, okay, so like, first of all, I'm so impossibly tame. I'm like, why are they calling it like dank? And then I realize, oh, this is like a weed thing, isn't it? And then I'm like, okay, fair enough. And then, like, everything becomes dank, and I'm like, okay, fair enough. I get it. You smoke pot. I mean, I live in BC. This is not exactly new information for most people.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever's in charge here probably knows where to find Loren. Then let's get to the office and find them.
Hello?
Yep.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure that you weren't talking.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Like, that you weren't cut off or something.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I know it's a little unusual when I'm not just giving a constant stream of consciousness.
Right, yeah, that's why I'm a little confused.
Are you okay, System Shock? Are you there?
Pretty much.
Oh, and hi, I am Ezra. I don't think I said hello to you earlier. You know, I don't know about slang words, but I will say one thing that needs to come back is a Tommy gun. Like, Tommy guns are, I think, one of the nicest looking weapons ever.
Really?
Yeah, don't you?
I don't know if it's necessarily the weapon or the whole sort of lifestyle surrounded it. Get to the manager's office.
Is there any way I can drop this massive piece of weaponry around hip level?
Well, you know, I think the best way to get rid of it is find somewhere to bury it inside of.
Ah.
Mm-hmm. You know, find a way to sheath it, basically. How do we get up there? Here?
How'd you get up there? Are you some like Assassin's Creed kind of?
I use the power of my nakedness. I just let everyone, or everyone just let me go on by. It's not about what they
want, okay? By the way, chat, if you haven't seen, Jesse Quill has done Ezio Auditore cosplay.
I have, yeah. I was playing Assassin's Creed and I cosplayed as Ezio because he's my favorite assassin. I'm up for more. I just love those womanizing Italians.
Oh, let me introduce you to my thesis advisor.
Mm-hmm.
You already see them. I think chat.
For you to get here.
Okay, well, chat. Oh, I think no, you can all tell exactly what I thought of the Ezio cosplay based on the voice that I'm using.
It was so boring that you're talking in a low voice because you're about to fall asleep.
I can see why that one might have a perception of that, but no. The stream is pure ear heaven.
Oh, ear heaven, yeah? Mm. Hello, Joshina. Wie geht's? Hoffentlich ganz gut. Meine Name is Jessica. Is that good? Is that good for you? It's good for me.
Joshy man, I don't know no fancy languages, but I just want to talk to this. You know what? I actually don't really even want to talk to you this way. I just want to make sure that people know I can speak in this tone of voice. Thank you for being my pie of reckoning. Why you gotta make me look like an idiot?
Ich bin glücklich. I am happy. Das ist gut. Pie of reckoning. You can surf.
Yep. I figure it's time we actually started co-oping. Are you deliberately making this a rough ride?
That is exactly what I am known for. Rough doesn't necessarily mean bad. As your character, yeah. Let's go.
Pierce, we've waited long enough. Now we go for Loren.
It won't be easy. That whole tower's gotta be called for Morningstar.
Since when have we done things the easy way?
True.
Come back, your car.
Kill everyone we see and find Loren?
Me?
Makes sense.
No.
Get the penthouse. I'll call Shandy.
Aha! Wrong car, you moron.
We're meeting at the penthouse.
I am gonna kill that son of a bitch.
Don't worry. You'll get away with
it.
My car now!
No!
Oh my god. Yes, please drive that everywhere.
I don't know. According to Francis Bacon, the job of the artist is to deepen the mystery. Anyway, here's Animal by Mike Snow.
Thanks for the ride.
There we go. Come on, guys. I'm really sensitive about my ability to play games. Why you gotta be so mean? I play Saints Row so people can respect my skill.
That's a little big for you.
Give me the goddamn gun, Pierce.
Okay.
All right, let's give that motherfucker what's coming to him.
This is so cool.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm never ever gonna fault the Saints Row series for their cinematic approach. Especially with my character's mustache. I mean, come on, guys, look at that. Look at that.
Shandi, you gonna be okay coming along? Don't worry about me. I need this. Loren has to pay for what he did, and I want to be there when he gets what he deserves.
Don't worry.
M'ladies, your chariot awaits. We're
taking out his whole oh, thank you, my lord.
I think we'll need to do a little more than kill one guy to do that.
You know that bomb we stole? Well, there you go.
How hard do you think finding Philippe will be?
He'll be on the top floor. I think it's in the criminal mastermind rulebook or something.
You
think
he's gonna oh, be Joshy, I'll show you my guns.
We're killing everyone in there.
Hello.
The crew's holding back, right? I don't want the giant bomb near a firefight.
Oh, it's all taken care of. As soon as we make sure the loading dock is clear, they'll drive it in.
Well, son of a bitch.
Gets the blood pumping.
To the hell?
Loins. Oh! How many times you gonna check that gun?
How long is it gonna take us to get there?
I was just asking.
I'll put you both in a timeout.
Bloody narrow streets. Almost like Venice.
How many places have you traveled to?
Australia and Canada. Oh no, that's not true. I've been occasionally to the US, but when I was really little, so I don't really count it. I would love to have traveled more, but I mean, obviously I've got the wrong priorities.
What do you mean the wrong priorities?
Yeah, you know, school.
That's not a wrong priority.
That one was for you, Johnny.
I've traveled to Germany and France.
And I see London, I see France, I see never mind.
One more, Chuck. One more goddamn cringy comment.
I'm cringy sorry, please.
Comment.
Anyway. Please continue.
So, Germany, France, a bunch of states in America, Australia, that's it. Why don't you tell me that you're getting choked out? I mean, I guess you like it, so never mind. I'll stop interrupting your little lover's quarrel over there.
Well, you know what? The solution was to fire my gun in his face, so.
Well, I mean, I guess I can understand why you don't want the action to end just yet.
Too easy. Now.
Joshy man, I lift all the m'ladies. Arm bomb.
Bomb setting, the clock's ticking.
Why didn't we wait to do that until after we kill Loren?
I don't know about getting choked out. I can understand getting choked is fun, but getting choked out where you pass out? I know people used to do that like in high school and stuff, and it was really scary.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, there would be like guys would go up behind each other and they would choke each other out. It was like a prank or whatever, I guess, that they did.
Jesus Christ!
Mm-hmm.
I mean, once I, for my brother, like, I came up behind him and gave him a bear hug, and he, like, went limp, like, completely unconscious. And I felt, like, terrible. And then,
oh, wow.
I mean, I realized my brother's, you know, not really worth worrying about. I'm kidding.
Yeah, right. Like, I know that it was something weird, but all those guys were like, no, we do it, like, it's just a prank, bro, like, that kind of stuff. And I was like, you know, you can hurt each other like really badly if you do that too often. Like, basically, what you're doing is cutting off oxygen supply to your brain. Like, that is not a good thing to do. They're like, yeah, but it feels really good or whatever. Like, they were basically masturbating each other by autoerotic asphyxiation.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
We probably should have seen that coming.
What?
Yeah, yeah. You're right. It's fucking crazy.
I went to a public middle of America high school.
I think I was just, you know, very sheltered. This is, I think every high school is the exact same, and that just my experience. I was too innocent. Oh, hello, fireman! Stop with the fire, man! Remind me to stay behind.
Sorry.
Well, not that I mind the view.
Behind is probably one of the best positions for this mission. Classmate was caught winking in the bathroom in high school. Well, that doesn't really hurt anyone. Like, you know, go ahead and do that. But
I mean, it's better than wanking in the classroom, right?
Right. Or like a teacher doing it. I mean, once again, the teacher can do it. Just close the damn stall, man. Okay, thank you, Ursa. I knew that I wasn't weird in remembering that people did do that. I wasn't ever okay with it, but people do what they want to do.
What the hell is all this?
See my favorite. Hello.
For being such a big man, he has such a small pixel covering himself.
For his rules, I am the master Petrus. It's the effect of
why are you still
steroids.
Up that they already cloned your ass?
The copies are flawed. They have my bro.
Cutscenes are best because I get to catch up with all my other media.
The last time a big naked dude said he could help me, it did not end well.
What could he do anyway? Those wires and shit are probably keeping him alive.
Trust me, I'm still strong enough to kill Philippe.
You want some clothes, man?
No time.
Man, like I said, last time a big naked dude.
This elevator will take us to the offices.
All right, the big finish.
Follow me to Philip's office.
Seriously, man, you know, if you want, I can find you like a curtain or something for you, you know?
The human body is nothing to be ashamed
of. Wow, all right, Pierce, unless you're bitching about
insecurities.
I'm good.
Got a name, honey?
My name
Oleg
is
being naked, but what
so,
about me?
What did
Sexist.
You do before you were a glorified pincushion?
I think it's best for our friendship I never elaborate. Just know that the enemy of your enemy is your friend. As long as you oppose the Syndicate, you have nothing to fear from me.
Then we'll be all good. Glad to have you in the Saints.
Ever hear about people using the excuse of accidentally having sex? Well, I mean, you might not intend to have sexual relations with someone, and then eventually the situations arise either because of you're under the influence of drugs or alcohol, or you have been sufficiently persuaded due to certain tactics, either coercion in a negative way or peer pressure for convincing in a positive way. Accidentally having sex, I don't think ever actually really happens. It's more of like, I didn't intend to have sex, but we did anyway. Sort
yeah,
of thing.
I am Ezra. I was actually thinking the same thing. It was a Saudi Arabian millionaire, so obviously the implication is that there was a miscarriage of justice.
What is that case? I don't remember hearing about it.
So apparently there is the claim that the guy tripped and fell.
Oh, yes. I remember that one now. Yeah.
Yeah. It's ridiculous.
So dumb.
I mean, apparently he was granted some, like, time behind closed doors with the jury or something like that. It's like, okay, so, you know, when he handed out those brown envelopes filled with cash.
He bribed them or threatened them, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, if you insist.
Leah 2, how's it going? You've come to a great stream.
Hello, Leah 2.
You really could have used an 80s action hero joke.
Time to blow this place to hell.
I hate this place more than anyone, but it would be folly to destroy Philip's research without seeing what we can harvest from it.
We came here to send a message, didn't we?
Why not keep the building for yourself?
Your choice here, boss.
Do you have a preference?
No, I think I blew it up last time, but I don't really care either way.
I mean, I'm okay with blowing it up. We'll usually have enough cash by the end, but...
Right, that's what I thought. Respect is... kind of important. Yes, Endors, you are right.
It's time we went back home and buried Johnny.
My emoji foo is very weak.
Why do you say that?
Just gotta find the right, can never find the right thing in the index.
Eventually you will become proficient. It's just like any language, you just have to practice.
It's like hieroglyphics.
Let me be specific, I want to get down in your South Seas. What?
Who just wrote that? Yeah, I think I was going to say, actually, I'm not really paying attention to the time, but I know it's getting relatively late for you. Did you want to do one more mission, or should we call it tonight?
It's 4 a.m. for me.
It's not really an answer.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear your question fully then.
Oh, I was just going to say, like, did we want to call it here, or did we want to do one more mission?
I can. I'm fine with that. Whatever works. I asked because I wanted your opinion.
Oh, sure. Yeah, I kind of like... I think, let's do one more because Leah, too, has joined us, but...
Sure.
I guess I should move past this window, huh?
Maybe. Actually, man, I'm a little confused. Your classmates thought you knocked up a girl because you had early childhood education and parenting skills? Like, what? Like, because you were educated, they thought that you knew that because of experience and not necessarily learning knowledge? That's what I got from that.
When I left Stillwater for the Senate, I vowed never to forget my hometown roots. My husband gave his life defending Stillwater from gang violence. It is my greatest privilege to honor him with this bridge.
Ecta.
Oh, Jesus. Thanks, Joshy. I think my intuitive comprehension skills are relatively proficient. Oh my.
whoever this crew is, they flow pretty damn good.
They're Killbane's thugs.
Kill who?
He's the Syndicate's a tech dog.
What he did to Johnny's funeral, that's over the fucking limit.
He doesn't care about rules of engagement.
No rules? I can work with that.
You're not ready to fight the Syndicate.
Watch us.
Hey, chat, what do you think of my character's hat?
All right, big man, what do you got?
There are others who hate the Syndicate as much as you do. I will take you to them.
Can you believe this? On my husband's bridge! No, I will not come down. I am heading back to the hill. Book an emergency session. God damn it, this is war.
I like the dedication that the Saints Row series does into portraying the U.S. political processes.
What's her deal?
Oleg said she was with the FBI.
Are you shitting me?
Don't stress. She was kicked out.
So we're getting a shitty fed.
Don't start.
Pretty Bolin.
Are you serious?
I'm not saying. I'm just saying.
I'm not jealous.
Who said jealous? That's all on you, girl.
Oh my god.
Yeah, great sexual tension. What got her kicked out?
Oleg didn't give me all the details, but he made it sound like Kinsey was about to out the Syndicate, so the Decker set her up for a fall.
Ugh. I hope she's worth the hassle.
Only one way to find out. We gotta get on that barge.
I don't suppose anybody would want to go for a boat ride.
I can show you the world. I mean, it's not a carpet, but it's close enough.
I remember when I was working in camera, there was a they were like all getting together on a like for some kind of a boat or something like that, and one of the crew came up and was like, you know, and like they were just talking about it constantly. So one of the crew members was like, so why are you guys so like worried about getting a boat? And then one of them just looks at them and says, it's quicker than gin. I'm not entirely sure. What does that mean?
Mm-hmm.
Well, gin has a certain reputation. Or at least I thought it was a universal reputation.
Or it's...
I'd always heard of it as the universal panty remover, so... Whether it's true or not, I don't know.
I should test that.
I actually like gin.
I never had gin, I don't think.
I mean, I'm very much a whiskey guy, but...
Mm. I like tequila and vodka.
Ooh. There is a drink at EXP called the Megaton.
Mm-hmm.
It is...
After Fallout 3.
Yeah, it's tequila and Jaeger, two shots, and then energy drink kind of down below. So you take the tequila, the Jaeger drops into the energy drink with the Jaeger bomb.
You don't seem that excited about
it's wonderful.
To see if you were sent to kill me.
Girl's pragmatic. I like her.
I think I need to go there and check it out, man. It sounds amazing.
You don't look like feds.
We heard that you know some people who hate...
Leotute, Jin has no such reputation over here as far as I know. Okay, I need to find a new group of people to hang out with.
Well, the DeWinters are keeping Zemos at Seaport.
What?
I always heard that tequila was the one that fucks people up and makes them remove panties.
All right. So apparently all of alcohol is... who knew it had this... wait a minute. Did they just have a safe word teacup? Have a good night, Pie of Reckoning.
Pie.
Yeah, apparently all alcohol has this reputation. Who would have known?
So interesting. Oh, yes, the BDSM club. I've been waiting for so long.
I am so glad we decided to do one more mission.
I think this is a great way
to end the night.
Mm-hmm.
You heard it here first, chat. Best way to end a night with Jesse Quill.
Going to the BDSM club.
I bet you'd be into some nasty shit if you tried.
Or maybe that's the beginning of a beautiful night.
Oh my god, you totally would.
Shut up.
Oh, hey, hit it harder next time.
Well, George if Clooney makes character. I know you didn't hear the line, so chat will just have to hear it. Sorry, please go ahead.
Ooh, so close.
George Clooney makes good tequila. I didn't know he made alcohol. Interesting.
So, when the car crashed,
someone's got to know where to keep
the my character said, "Hit it harder next time." I'm like, "Well, you know, if you insist."
Yeah, Joshy man, it's like it's my jam. I don't know. I couldn't even say that with a straight face.
Tell me where Zemos is, or I'm gonna beat you stupid.
Oh, yes!
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
The manager's upstairs, and he ain't no. Just take me. I've been bad.
I mean, are you gonna finish him off? Like,
I love these interrogation. I mean, I'm horrified by these interrogation moments, but I love them as scenes.
I mean, I'm gonna give him what he wants.
I always win my arguments.
I'm kind and generous.
You the manager?
I don't even know
what
to call
anything.
It.
I'm just here for a bachelor party.
Slave driver?
Wow! Look what I threw him into, chat. This game.
Oh my god.
Still got it.
Well, there's some definitely very interesting. Oop.
Sorry.
It's all fun and games until someone dies.
So where do we start looking?
Shake people down. My bad.
Someone's got to know where they're keeping
up. He just got overexcited. It's okay. I understand. I have that effect on people.
Jesus Christ. See you, chat. I'm off for the night.
Either take me to Zemos or I'm going to beat your sorry ass.
Oh, yes!
Seriously?
Ugh. The manager's upstairs. He ain't no... Just take me. I've been bad.
In fairness, you're not exactly... Why did I go to that room again? In fairness, you know, you are a little underdressed for the occasion.
Me?
Yeah, for the interrogation.
Ah, yes.
You the manager?
I don't know anything. I'm just here for a bachelor party.
I would love to have a bachelor party here.
I'll stay in one of those cages so nobody can get me.
Zemos, where is he?
If I say anything, the De Winter sisters will cut me off.
Funny, I was thinking of cutting something off too.
He's in the pony barn. All right.
I always win.
I've been ignoring chat, but I love the reactions to that room.
I mean, whatever your fetish is, it's fine.
Ever see this place again? It'll be too soon.
Oh, I'm gonna have to.
How are we gonna find Zemos? Look for the cat in here who isn't excited to be eating a ball gag?
Or just look for the guy with the rhinestone Z on his back.
Fuck out of here, man. Oh, well, shit, that's convenient.
They went this way. Oh, shit.
We don't got time, Zemos. Mush!
This is such a ridiculous sequence.
I mean, this is actually a thing, so...
What?!
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Well... It's like BDSM culture, and they have sort of a humiliation fetish, or like being used as a toy or a tool, and so that's basically what this is.
Right.
Sorry about making you, pull us around.
This is a rescue, right? This ain't some elaborate setup for a gangbang.
Why you gotta put that image in my head,
bro? Oh, I go with rescue then. I would shake your hands, but them floors were a little sticky, if you know what I'm saying.
Where did my character take out her cell phone from?
Find a towel or something. What's up?
Found the guy you're talking about. His name's Angel de la Muerte. He was Killbane's tag team partner until he went crazy.
Who went crazy? Angel or Killbane?
I should probably look into that. The point is, Angel hates Killbane more than you do. You should be willing to help.
Got a location?
That's the tricky part. The luchadors are attacking him at the gym right now. You should probably hurry before he gets killed.
And that didn't come first. Why?
I saw what you tried.
Hurry up, you're on the clock.
Thanks, player. I appreciate you busting me out.
You're welcome. And let's
also, Joshy Man, what spray?
I don't know.
Do I even want to know what spray actually is the more important question?
Yeah, especially back in that BDSM club. I don't know. Oh, good. I'm glad you have critical thinking skills, Joshy.
Maybe she uses Google Glass.
Google Ass? Sorry, I didn't quite hear you.
I never want to get a phone call from one of those. Although, it would stop people from asking me, like, to borrow my cell phone.
Well, I don't know. Maybe some people would be very interesting. Or interested.
They would definitely be interesting people. It was very relaxing when somebody else is driving.
Right, yeah.
This bumper can take it.
You know, Leo 2, it's actually, it's kind of funny because I was in the same position as you until, of course, you so kindly donated number 5. I really like the Saints Row series because it didn't take itself seriously. That it very much kind of captured, you know, kind of the, I don't know, the recklessness and like just the sort of the pure fun of the GTA style of game. But it didn't try to tell like a serious story. It just kind of wanted to outdo itself with its set pieces. Whereas I sort of got the impression that some GTA games were, like, they were trying to tell a more serious story, but, like, had the life perspective of somebody who only, like, watched Martin Scorsese movies. I mean, that may be unfair to... I mean, that may be unfair to some of the designers of the earlier GTA games, but... Well, I guess I should get out of the car, huh?
Maybe.
But Leah, yeah, Leah too. I mean, the big thing here is, I mean, I think the nice thing is that the best would be, of course, if we could like both. But it's kind of nice that we're at a point where we can have a bit of diversity in terms of these things. So you know, for people who like a very, you know, absurd take on these kinds of crime games. You can pick up Saints Row, and then if you like something maybe a little bit more serious, then they can pick up GTA. And if you just like playing these kind of sort of open worldish sort of games, then
you get both.
Exactly. And
I really enjoy
broke.
Both of them. Yeah, I really enjoy both series a hell of a lot. Oh, those are cars.
Yeah, well, that's the big one for me, Leah, too. Like, I really can't take a lot of GTA games seriously, but I think, like, the big appeal to me about Saints Row is it just tries to, like, give this complete send-up to, you know, to these kinds of games.
And so. You are not one of Kilbane's luchadors.
Pick up Skyrim? Sorry, Andrews? Oh, open world. Gotcha.
this imposter to me.
Yeah, T. Clark, that's exactly how I feel about it too. I always thought that GTA kind of
kill him, like, goddammit,
semi-seriously, but not completely. Like, I knew that it was silly and it made jokes, but it did have a more serious plot to it. Jack's a great caster. He
figured it out indoors.
Like, here I thought I, like, did something legitimately good, and there's like, nope, he just wasn't a moron. We need to reward him, otherwise...
That's not what I meant.
I know. I always have to turn it into the worst.
It's gonna make me feel really bad about giving you compliments.
Oh... Okay, now thanks for making me feel bad.
Good. My character might die. Oh. I was a little reckless earlier.
I'll save you, m'lady.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm okay. I healed up a little bit. Not very much. I'm getting fired.
I always thought you were able to shoot the fuel tanks, but it doesn't seem to actually be happening.
My goodness, Leotu, that would be absolutely fantastic, but just think about the programming and stuff needed for that. I think you would have to... This would have to be like a virtual reality AI sort of thing, and I think that's probably the next step of... After, like, we have regular virtual reality or, you know, with the Oculus Rift and stuff, I think that would be another amazing step for gaming where we basically... I don't know if anyone's read the books, Ready Player One? Where we basically just live inside of these little, oh, Jesus. Oop, I might have died. Oh, no, I'm okay.
Okay here, yeah.
I was, like, in a kill. It was killing me. Oh, my God, and I'm on fire. Stop, stop.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Philippe is dead. And we are at a crossroads. And the question is, who will lead the Syndicate to a new era?
Viola and Kiki were Mr. Loren's right hands.
I had someone else in mind.
Excuse me?
The Syndicate has to answer for what they did. And this time, we're taking the fight to them. Since we don't know Steelport, I brought in some people who do. This is Kinsey. Zemos, an angel.
The barbarians are at the gate. We need a general, not an ambassador.
Calm down, Eddie.
What did you call me?
What would you like us to do, Kilbane?
Something. Anything. Before I wonder why I keep you bookends around.
Talk to one of these guys. They'll have things for you to do. It's our time now. Let's get this shit started.
Yeah.
This is a really good choice for a game.
Yeah, I love this game.
I haven't tried Gat Out of Hell. I've only got 3 and 4, but I think it's a pretty...
I didn't try Gat Out of Hell either.
Oh, apparently I didn't need to buy the Penetrator. I would have gotten it from this mission.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you live, you learn. All right, I think it's a good time to stop.
Sure.
All right, I will sign off to all you lovely people. Thank you very much for hanging out. I know, especially between Yip and I, it was a little bit of a it was a little bit of a different style of stream, right? It was definitely very informal because I was learning the game. Even this time, right, I was sort of interacting with chat, but not really. But with that in mind, you know, I definitely had a lot of fun hanging out with you guys, and it seems like you guys did as well. I definitely don't get numbers like this, so I really appreciate it. I'd like to take a minute to recognize the four people hosting us tonight: Ak Akadak, Rith Ronir, Elkanu, who I hope is asleep, and most importantly, Jesse Quill, the co-caster tonight, who very patiently endured me sort of, I guess, solo playing Risk of Rain for so long. And then joined me for Saints Row the Third, and I had an absolute blast of a time, especially because she has this very unique way of making me tongue-tied with an appropriately sharp-tongued comment. But
of course.
I suppose that is some of the reason. I think the feedback has always been that people like these co-casts, and certainly I don't mind being the punchline. But I mean, it's also very nice to have the be on side with such a talented caster. All of these people are worth checking out. Again, especially when it comes to Akadak, somebody who is infrequent in streaming but deserves every single follow that he gets. Elkanu, who streams in French but really is a guy you can learn from when it comes to timing, camera presence, selection of games. He's a very, very talented caster, and I mean, it would be nice to see some support for stuff which is for a specific group. In the end, English is a very well-known language in the world, but it would be nice that if Twitch's reach could become global, that it was a platform where people didn't go to certain language streams because it was the only option in town, but they had the sort of selection that you and I do. And so, again, I mean, if it's really important that you understand every word that's being said, that's fine. But for those of you who want to become casters yourself, Elkanu is a very good opportunity to learn, because he has all of these skills and you can divorce it from the words that are being said. So, in my case, I sometimes hear, I wish I had a vocabulary like yours. That's very kind to hear, but that isn't necessarily the source of any engagement. It's a part of my personality, but it's not the reason why people would want to watch the stream, I don't think. So, and then, of course, finally, as I said, Jesse Quill, somebody who requires no introduction to this audience, but I will still very strongly recommend anyway, somebody who's given so much of herself to this stream to get us where we are, but to the people who watch her as well. There's not enough that can be said about this stream. It's wonderful. It's great to go to. I learn something every time I go there. She has tremendous ability to entertain people. Beautiful facial expressions. I mean, if nothing else, you should go there because of the way that she's able to convey meaning directly through her facial expressions. But most importantly, too, I mean, it's very easy to look at a stream like that, see a very good-looking woman playing a video game, and it's like, okay, I'll hang out. This is nice to look at. But I mean, if that's where the conversation stops, then there's just so much being missed. It's such a wonderful stream to hang out at, and it just ticks all the boxes. Everything about it that you would consider to be essential to Twitch is in there, and so another opportunity to learn. But in some cases, one where really everything is kind of turned up to 11, so it's sometimes a little intimidating to try and emulate. So instead, I just kind of bring her on cast, and I try to let a little bit of her talent rub off on me.
Oh, thank you so much. You're incredibly kind.
No problem. Although I guess if I was really kind, I would have said the entire shout out in this tone. All right, guys. Jesse Quill, did you have anything you wanted to say to chat before we sign off?
Thank you so much. Everyone, for hanging out and chatting, not only in System Shock stream earlier, but then mine as well, and then our co-cast. I appreciate the support of everyone chatting and retweeting and sharing their life stories and antidotes, and hopefully we'll see you again soon.
I was thinking we've got a couple of Team Panda members, although I wanted to check, was there anybody that you wanted to, I mean, I guess technically you can host whoever you want on your own, but I haven't hosted Platinum Hamster in a while, and he's playing Diablo 3.
I was just thinking him.
All right.
Great.
Then I'm going to give you all a raid message, and I would love it if you could come and help out my friend Platinum Hamster, fellow Team Panda member, who is playing Diablo 3. I really should just turn this into a command.
Yeah.
All right, guys, there is the link and the quote. Feel free to stop by his channel, drop that in there, and enjoy some Diablo 3. As for me, I will do my best to kind of announce ahead of time when I'm going to be streaming again. I've got a couple of things that I need to do, but as always, I like doing this. Whenever I do it, you guys really reward me, and so I want to make sure that I can return the favor by giving you some content to watch. We've got a lot of irons in the fire. We've got LA Noire, we've got Mass Effect, we've got Shadowrun Hong Kong we're going to get back to at some point, Gabriel Knight. They're all stuff I really like playing, and it's just a matter of finding the time and finding the right balance. So anyways, I got to shut up. Let's go see Hamster and see what he's up to.